2020 Hillside High School Performing Arts Awards Ceremony. This year is a little different than any other year. Like everyone else around the world, we are social distancing, both physically and socially. However, nothing can stop that haunted pride. We are live. Tonight, we will be honoring our performing arts students in chorus, band, dance, and theater. Our performing arts department is led by Ms. Tiffany Aggerston, Ms. Sybil Haskins, Ms. Valencia Lipscomb, and I am Wendell Tabb. We are blessed here at Hillside High School to have the best principal in the world. Please welcome our principal, Dr. William T. Logan.
Great evening, everyone. It is certainly a pleasure to be here with you this evening. I haven't felt this much energy ever sitting in front of a computer. And so to Mr. Tabb and Ms. Adgerston, thanks for doing such an immaculate job kicking this program off this evening. To all of our distinguished guests, Dr. Mubinga, I see Mr. Freelon, Ms. Fairley, Ms. Mason, just looking from my screen, just welcome all of you, alumni, friends, family, students especially. I just want to welcome you all to this event. I'm certainly elated to be here. Every year, it seems like when this event is held, I'm out of town. Normally this time of year, I'm actually usually going home to visit family. And so this is my first time actually being able to participate in the Performing Arts Awards ceremony. So certainly excited to see what tonight has in store. To our students, I just want to thank you all for your commitment, your time, your energy, and your dedication to the arts. It certainly is certainly has paid off in the years, in years past, and certainly this year has been different for you, but it still didn't diminish what you all deliver in the form of the arts. To all of my colleagues, Mr. Tabb, Ms. Adgerston, Ms. Haskins, Ms. Lipscomb, thank you all, thank you all, thank you all. Mr. Pierce, I see you out there. What's up, frat? always great to see you, man. Thank you for all that you've done to contribute to Hillside High School's success. And without further ado, I'm going to turn it back over to the MC. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Logan. We all love and appreciate you so much. Our students have gone through a lot this year, but they were resilient, committed, and dedicated. And we thank God for that. As the late Dr. Chuck Davis would say, let us give thanks. We will now have an invitation by the talented Ms. Tiffany Aggerston.
Thank you for an opportunity to give you thanks tonight. We thank you for what you have already done and for what you plan to do. Lord, we honor you. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you so much, Ms. Aggerston. We have an exciting for you all tonight. So just sit back, relax, and enjoy our Performing Arts Awards ceremony. Now we'll be zooming in from around the world. People from all over the world will be zooming in tonight to say hello and congratulations to our wonderful performing arts students. Right now, let's see who's out there for the student who've been working so hard. Well, I tell you what, let's go to a highlight reel from the last 4 years of Hillside. Take a look. that was a highlight reel for over the past 4 years. Now, if you were listening to that music, hopefully you recognize those two voices from Hillside graduates, our very own Shirley Caesar and John P. Key. We love calling them our very own. They are graduates of Hillside High School, so we're excited to have them be a part of our Performing Arts Award ceremony. Ms. Agerston, before we give out the very first awards, let's go around the world and see who is out there.
Love to Mr. Tab. On the Zoom line is, oh my goodness, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Chester Gregory.
We see, where is Chester? Is Chester muted?
I'm right here.
There we go, Chester. Ladies and gentlemen, our celebrity guest from Broadway, from Motown, played Barry Gordy, Dr. Chester Gregory. Thank you for Zooming. Where are you Zooming in from, Chester?
Well, right now I am in LA. I spent the last 2 months back home in Gary, Indiana with my mom, and I just got back to LA this week. So I'm back, you know, in my apartment now.
Great. Well, welcome back to Hillside High School. We are virtual this time. What are you asking for these wonderful performer arts students? You just saw them last year.
Well, I wanted to say thank you all so much for having me. It was an honor and a blessing to be a part of the program this fall. And I love the production of The Bodyguard. It was beautiful. It was amazing. And so just as the class of 2020, as you all get ready to go out into the world, I just want to give you some things that I found to be useful. Okay, so I actually learned this when I took a leadership class shortly before I went to Hillside. So When we have tasks that we have to do in the daytime, we usually say, well, I gotta do this, I gotta do that, and I gotta do that, right? But when you just slightly alter the framing to say, I get to do this, I get to do that, I get to do these things, and then it becomes a little bit, again, the same task, but your perspective gets a little better. So then from this leadership class that I learned, is the highest vibration you can set is to say that I am blessed to do these things. And so when you say, I am blessed to put gas in the car, I'm blessed to go to work, I'm blessed to do this, it frames it in a way where you're able to go through the task with gratitude. And then I was in this class for a full week, and this was the first time I spoke on a class. They didn't say anything the whole time. They thought I was a mute. They thought I couldn't talk. And so what I learned, people were saying, well, I get to put gas in the car because there's a lot of people that don't have cars. I get to go to work because there's a lot of people that don't have jobs. Then I spoke my hand for the first time. And I said, I like to think that I'm blessed to do the things I'm able to do, not because somebody else doesn't have it, but because I remember when there was a time when I didn't have it. And so now I'm grateful for those things. And so anyway, so I just wanted to share that framing that even amidst of all these terrible things that are happening in the world, we can still approach our day-to-day tasks with gratitude and the highest vibration and get out here and make a change and difference in the world.
So Dr. Gregory, we want to just thank you from Zooming in from Los Angeles, California. We're so blessed to have you. Thank you for being a part of our Celebrities in the Classroom program. We love you. Thank you very much. Ms. Agerston, let's go. Who else is out there? Let's zoom around the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Travis Lawson.
Hey guys, how's it going? I'm actually, I've been in Australia for the last 10 years, but I actually made it during COVID-19 to be here in North Carolina. So I'm here with you guys now and I want to say hello. It's been a long time. This is the longest time I've actually spent in America in the last few years. So it's a pleasure to be here, a pleasure to see all of you guys today. I can't believe it's been almost 18 years since being in the Hillside program. You know, I was the technical director running the sound and engineering, and a lot of what I'm doing now is, you know, building out a media company in Australia and working with, you know, some of the largest companies in the world and, you know, commercials and films and things of that nature. So I feel that the foundation started actually at Hillside. So one of the most important things I would actually give you guys as encouragement is to always keep in mind your purpose and don't ever let anyone take that away from you. It's hard to, you know, go through life and there's gonna be a lot of things that come at you, It's going to be a lot of things that you have to go through. And, you know, you guys are at your age right now, but, you know, when you get up in age, you'll start to see life will throw itself at you. But if you keep in mind what you're here to do, don't let anyone take that away from you. And I want to thank you, Mr. Tapp, for encouraging me and encouraging everyone that you've been part of, and as well as the other people at Hillside Teaching. You know, Miss Wilder, I see you in here too. Hello, it's been years. I remember what you were saying a long time ago at the soundboard, don't ever forget about us, you know, and that was almost 18, 20 years ago. I really appreciate all that you guys have poured in. I can also say that, you know, Hillside has one of the most remarkable programs, you know, in the world as far as performing arts. You know, I've got to travel to several countries and I've talked to people, and they're literally people from all over the world. And it's interesting to hear that the type of exposure that we had, the type of even the program that we had, that's not something that's very normal. So, you know, thank you guys for sacrificing. I know there was a lot of sacrifice when it came to performances, you know, handling all the students. And, you know, students, I think it's a really good opportunity just to, you know, understand what you guys have, and then going out into the world, know where you came from, and never forget that. So that's all I got to say. Good to see you guys.
Thank you so much, Travis. And, you know, best wishes to you in Australia. I know you've been there for a long time. And so thank you for all that you're doing. We're going to go to two more celebrities, and then we're going to go to further in the program, and then we'll come back and introduce some more people from around the world. But now I want to go to Hillside graduate, Mr. Gregory Horton, who is a national renowned costume designer, a graduate of Hillside High School. And then Gregory Horton, I'd like for you to introduce our celebrity, Dr. Stewart. Can you do that?
I can do that, sir. How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
Oh my God. So I was just listening to Travis and he was saying 20 years. Oh my God. I think I'm going to be, it's going to be 38 years. That I was at Hillside High School. What's really wonderful is Hillside High School poured into me more than you ever know the amount that was poured into me. As a student and as a professional. And I got to come back several times to work with Tab and the students, and it was fantastic. If I can say anything to the students today, I would say focus, press on, and don't let anybody tell you no. No only means not now. It doesn't mean that it's no forever. And so if you continue to ask, then it shall be given to you. And I've had a wonderful, wonderful career. Right now, I'm not that far from you. I'm in Greensboro, North Carolina, but I was in St. Louis for some time, and I was at renowned Alabama State University for some time with my friend and sister, who I'm about to introduce to you, Dr. Tommy Tonia Stewart, who is the baddest woman on the planet. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce to you Dr. Tonia Stewart.
Unmute, Dr. Stewart. Unmute. Tell her unmute, Greg. Can you get her attention?
Hey, Doc, can you unmute? Click your unmute. Hey, hey.
Okay. Is that better?
Yeah,
there you go.
Whew, I was trying. Listen. When I think of Hillside High and Gregory Horton and Wendell Tapp, I know, listen, you all are ready for the world. This is a pleasure, an honor. Hillside High is recognized all over the world. People talk about you all when you're sleeping. You have no idea. And Starletta Dubois worries my ears off talking about how great you are. I look forward to getting to the campus to see those who are following in your footsteps, because every one of you have been a trailblazer. You've been a leader. You've been a peacemaker. And at the same time, you've been a career goal setter. Each one of you graduating today, you're graduating in the year 2020, when the world is in complete chaos. And that means that everything is breaking down for you to have your beginning, a new start. Only God can make the chaos that we're experiencing, and only God can fix it. And you are fixed in it. You are appointed, you are anointed to do it. Don't stop. Believe in yourself and believe in the Savior that you serve. Understand that you don't make yourself breathe. And when you breathe, you don't know what you're breathing in. Only He does. So our faith, our belief, and the talent that He's given you to be a Chester, to be a Lee, to be a Travis, to be a Greg Horton, to be a Wendell Taft, comes from something deep within our ancestors. The prayers that they laid up for us, all that they endured, you're getting the just rewards that you deserve. God bless every one of you. Oh, thank you, Wendell, for what you're doing.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Stewart. Just tell quickly the young people the stuff that you've been in so they know.
Oh, now you see, I have to say this first. My grandmother taught me a long time ago, in her broken English, she said, anytime you got to tell folks who you is, you ain't much.
No, you a whole lot. They just so young. They on next all the time.
Okay, you all probably see me on In the Heat of the Night as Aunt Etta, Virgil's aunt, the old lady taking care of the twins. And a wonderful experience for me was A Time to Kill, playing the wife to Samuel L. Jackson. And of course, in the Rosa Parks story and so many other television shows and movies and stage plays. And I just retired as Dean of the College of Visual and Performing Arts at Alabama State University, where I had the chance to work side by side with Gregory Horton, and he has become my brother, my best half. I just love me some Gregory Horton. So when Hillside High sent out into the world people like you, Greg,
uh-huh.
Ooh, Lord, it's just a blessing, a wonderful blessing. I'm from Mississippi. I grew up in the Delta of Mississippi, in the flatlands where everybody's poor. And I had to believe all those years, where you come from does not dictate where you will end up.
Exactly.
Okay?
Right.
All right. So thank all the celebrities for opening this up. We have a lot of other slots for you guys, but we're going to move right on through now. So thank you all so very much. We are blessed to have celebrities from all over the world to be a part of our program here at Hillside High School. As it goes on, who knows? Others may Zoom right in. We all know why these students are here tonight. So let's get started with some awards. First up is chorus awards. And we have our very own talented and gifted chorus teacher, Miss Tiffany Aggerson, to present those awards.
Thank you, Mr. Tab. Don't forget, tonight, you can capture all of your favorite moments by using hashtag HillsideBPA2020. While you're watching, take a selfie. That's for students, parents, friends, alums, and celebrity guests. Everyone can get in on the fun. It is an honor and a privilege to recognize these outstanding students in chorus. This year, our students have made amazing accomplishments in such a short time. They have honored the legacy of our chorus teachers, participated in the North Carolina Music Performance Adjudication Festival, and rendered beautiful music in our community. Tonight, I honor all of you. Receiving our leadership awards tonight are Yadira Rincon Reyes, Julicia Robertson, Disney DeBerry, Tamaya Waden, Zayana Hinton, Jalen Hall, and Yadira Hicks. Most dedicated, Brianna Collins, Tanya James, Kamora Jones, Misty Wise, Jadira Hicks, Angela Holmes, Michael Sneed, Tyvell Brody, Kiara Yeager, and Jasmine Gers-Diaz. Our rising stars, Javion Richardson, Josiah Harris, Essence Mathis, Jania Sowell, Denexi Nunez, Robert Johnson, Armani Trainum, Luis Luarte, and Antoine Frazier. Our spirit awards are Kayla Atkins, Tanaya Ray, Nina Shapiro, Paige Clemens, Ariana Gray, Jordan Burton, Avanti Akpin, Janaya Rogers, Olivia Taylor, Jada Atwater, Shaquana Johnson, Denisha Jones, and Allure Teasley. Our most improved goes to Sajad James, Denasia Gilba, Dominic Holloway, and Tony Davis. Finally, our master musicians, Ziana Hinton, My Asia Chambers, Daryl Thompson, Nakaya Atkins, Dylan Smoke, and Tamaya Waiten. More awards are to be presented, but thank you to all of the students who have received these departmental awards. This program is built on legacy, and you all are a part of that legacy. We honor the late Miss Teresa Claggett, Miss Gloria Timberlake, and Mr. Carlton Miles. All of our chorus trailblazers have been lighting the way. Let's zoom into some of those trailblazers now. Miss Paula Nunn Lacewell and Mr. Anthony Pierce.
We will begin with Miss Lacewell.
Unmute myself. Can you hear me now?
Yes, yes.
Hi, my name is Paula Nunn Lacewell. I'm so glad to say to the graduating class of 2020, I am so proud of the accomplishments that you've done. And I had some things that I want to say to you. I have a couple of things, but I want you, when you go out into the world, make your mark. Make your mark. Whatever you do, do the best you can do. So when somebody sees your name, they say, oh, I know so-and-so. Joe did that. I'm going to see that. Or I'm going to be a part of that. Because whatever Joe does, he makes sure it's done with the high quality, the best that he can do. And also write down your vision, young people. Write down your vision. Look at it every day. And say, this is where I want to go. This is the road I want to take. This is how I want to do it. And do it. Go to it and do it. Paula Lacewell. Thank you, sir, for all you do.
Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Lacewell. Thank you for everything you've done at Hillside High School in chorus. Now we'll go to Mr. Anthony Pierce.
Mr. Anthony Bronte Pierce, hailing from Washington, D.C. I was the chorus teacher at Hillside from 2008 to 2014. And in that time, I just like to say that I know that Hillside is one of the, from being up here, Hillside has a, you all are blessed to be a part of that program. You would think that a city such as Washington, D.C. would have some great programs, but no. Hillside has been my best experience. And I know if it was my best experience as a teacher, I definitely know that Ben, you all being a part of the performing arts department there are steps above, levels above those that you're about to come in competition with. Continue to strive for greatness because you all come from greatness. Just keep it going. For the chorus members specifically, so I want to say continue to find your voice, develop your voice, and be a threat to those that you're about to go sing against and sing with. Show them who Hillside has prepared you to be. Again, just keep on doing what you're doing. Thank you, Mr. Tab, for letting me be a part of the program. Thank you, Ms. Agerson, cousin, for keeping the light going with chorus. Thank you, Ms. Lacewell, who's my student teacher, and Ms. Minifort Brown, who was my professor in NCCU. Good to see you. Everybody else, oh, Josh, what's going on, bro? And y'all just keep doing what you're doing. That's all I got to say. Keep being great.
Thank you, Mr. Pierce. Ms. Agerson.
Gentlemen, we have a dynamite band program led by an awesome band director. Here to present the band awards is Miss Sybil Haskins.
Thank you, Miss Agerson. It is an honor and a privilege to recognize the outstanding students in band. These students have made amazing accomplishments, including collegiate performances, middle school recruitment tours, and much more. So tonight, I honor you with the awards in the following categories. For our classes, outstanding excellence in the classroom, first period goes to Kayla Miles and Antonio Whitfield. Third period goes to Mr. Marlon McCoy. And fourth period, Mr. Ryan Long and Fredea Branch. Watch out now, we have yet another landing. This music legend, top band and chorus at Hillside High School, zooming in live, it is Mr. Xavier Kaysen.
Good evening, everybody. How you doing? Coming to you live from Throne Life Music Studios, or otherwise known as the Room Down the Hall. I just want to say it's such a great, great pleasure to see you. I'm scrolling through these pictures and faces and names. I'm trying to hold back the tears. You know, anybody who knows me well knows that I love a good story. I mean, every dance and theatrical movement is a story. Every piece of artwork, every color is a story. And band students, you know that every cadence, every song is a story. And especially for you, class of 2020, you know that you've got a story to tell, and only you get to tell it. So you get to shape that story. You get to say how this moment shaped the rest of your life. And we are so looking forward to hearing that story and all the many different ways that you're going to present it. So proud of you. So glad to be here amongst such great, great people. And thanks for inviting me to be a part of this.
Thank you, my brother. Thank you, Dr. Kaysen.
We thank you for your guidance and words of encouragement, Mr. Kaysen.
Can you hear
Hillside
me?
Band marches on through the rich history of our famed band directors. Chronicled in sequence is the late Mr. William Cole and Mr. Fillmore Shorty Hall. Living legends include Dr. Joseph T. Mitchell, Mr. Clark Edgerton, and the Mr. Xavier Kaysen, Mr. Christopher Hayes, and Mr. Darrell White. Tonight, we also celebrate your strides for keeping the arts alive in our city, state, and nation. We thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, this star needs no introduction. She uses her talents with children on the dance floor at Hillside to the television studios of Atlanta, Los Angeles, and beyond. Please welcome our incredible dance teacher, Miss Valencia Lipscomb.
Thank you, Miss Haskins. It is an honor and a privilege to recognize these outstanding students in dance. Our students have also made amazing accomplishments, such as capturing first place 2 consecutive years in a row in the North Carolina State Dance Championship competition, and being requested by Miss Minnie Fort Brown, thank you, to perform for the North Carolina Board of Education Conference. The Hillside Dance Department continues to inspire the community as professional performers with grace, distinct execution, and unique style. They honestly cannot be duplicated. I was a part of the program, and I saw that then as a kid looking up to the program. I saw it then too, and now I see it as the teacher. I'm honored. Tonight, we will honor our dancers from class with the following award. With leadership, most creative, and most improved. For first period, leadership award goes to Savannah Carr. For most creative in first period goes to Ada Rucker. For most improved, I had to give it to Nina Jackson and Viviana Davila. Congratulations. For third period, leadership, we have Kalia Green. For most creative in third period, we have Zamaria Patterson. And for most improved, we have Aaliyah Moore. Congratulations, ladies. And finally, for fourth period, we have leadership, Jade Scott Kirkland. For most creative, we have Jane Lim. And for most improved, we have Dasani Atwater and Sanai Marshall. Congratulations. If you see those students or talk to them, please congratulate them. I am so proud of the dance students, and more awards are forthcoming. As a student of the Hillside Dance Program, I am honored to be able to carry on this dance legacy. The legacy began with Miss Lisa Wilder and Miss Nicole Oxendine. Zooming in live, those dance legends are here right now. Let's welcome Mrs. Wilder. Miss Wilder, are you there?
I am. Thank you, Miss Lipscomb.
First, I would like to thank you for continuing to cultivate dance excellence at Hillside High School. Hillside has a very, very precious place in my heart. And I love every time I come back and I'm able to just sit back and I'm a proud mama. And so I'm the places that y'all have taken the program since I've been there, I am just overjoyed. Ladies and gentlemen, the kids, oh my goodness. Dancers, y'all are wonderful. And continue dance excellence. Continue to show what Hillside can produce as performing arts students. I'd like to congratulate the dance classes for their superlative awards and the company for the awards they're gonna get later on. And for all of the performances that you did get a chance to do this year, because just because we didn't finish out the year, that does not steal our shine. Y'all are excellent without excuse. And I love you, and continue your wonderful progress. Continue to dance. When you go out, you seniors, go out there and show what Hillside has to offer. Go out and continue to shine and be bright stars, as some of the guests are here tonight coming back, and some of the teachers that are right there, and they are stars as well. I am so proud because I got to teach a lot of y'all. It was so wonderful. Continue to reach for everything that you want in life. I'm so proud of you. This is your night. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Ms. Wilder. I appreciate you being here. I'm always happy to see you. So graciously, I had a blessed opportunity to work under both amazing women. But very closely, I worked along with this next amazing teacher. Miss Oxidine, are you there?
Yes, hello. This is Miss Ox calling in or zooming in from downtown Durham. And this is so exciting to see. And I am so proud of you all. And just the legacy that continues. I'm so proud of Valencia, and I'm so excited to carry on the legacy that Miss Wilder has set forth, and to study under Mr. Tabb and Mr. Kaysen, and you know, teach Miss Agerston and work with Mr. Pierce. So it's just been an amazing piece to see the legacy of Hillside and the performing arts continue, especially just with all the work that I know that you all put into this program, into your year, into the performances. Congratulate all the students that in the dance classes that just won awards, and just really, I guess that's just the biggest thing is I'm so excited. I'm so happy. I don't have as many eloquent, wonderful words as Ms. Wilder. I'm definitely one that I can dance it better. And I will say you all wish you the best as you move forward into this new world and use this time to be able to create, to ideate, to connect, to be at one with the universe and just really listen and hear about what your purpose is. And that's a lot of what I believe in, that work, walk in purpose. And, you know, this is, you know, don't take this as being a sad or a bad time, but just what is that speaking to you about what it is that's most important? This is a time that you can really say, this is what's so important to you. Like, if this is your art, if this is what it is, then you go for it. If it's whatever that is, use this time to just really hone in and listen to that voice that's guiding you in your life for what you want to accomplish. This is not the end. This is only the beginning of something. Just think of this as a clean slate to kind of enter the world and be intentional around what your purpose is in life.
Thank you, Ms. Oxendon. That was amazing. So we have all these amazing, amazing dance pioneers here that came right out of Hillside. I see you, Santron. But we have another amazing dance representative representing Durham Public Schools and the whole community. Ladies and gentlemen, zooming in with us tonight, please welcome my favorite, everyone's mom, Miss Toya Chandler.
Hi, everyone. I'm sitting here, I'm getting all teared up. I worked with Miss Wilder. I saw I was there when Nicole was coming up and her sister was my student. I was there when Valencia was a baby growing up, but understand I'm still young. And it is amazing. I've always been a great supporter and lover of Hillside High School for eons ever since I came to Durham, North Carolina. I'm originally from New Jersey, but I will tell you this, the students at Hillside and especially the dancers train like New York dancers. They are trained, and that was never more evident than this year. Unfortunately, the evening of entertainment did not get to come to fruition, but I tell you this, that choreography that Nicole Oxendine and her team were putting together, and those Hillside High School students, let me tell you this, Valencia Lipkin, you are training them to be professionals. They are professionals in their own right because they came in rehearsal. I don't care what time, I don't care in what way they came in. They got to it. They got to the business. They got to doing it. They didn't have to be retaught, relearned. They asked educated, professional questions, and they took it to the next level. And I know Nicole Oxenac can amen me on that one for sure. So it is with sadness that they didn't get to perform, but honeys, know this. You are excellent in your work. You have taken dance and will continue to take dance to the next level. Continue to know who you are as a dancer and be humble in your spirit, but be vigilant in your work and your ethics, and you will go far. And I have your t-shirts. I have your EOE t-shirts. I picked them up yesterday, and I'm working toward making sure you are honored, those seniors that did not get to perform, but you will be graduating. I'm working on getting you some kind of significant regalia to accompany you in your graduation attire. So I'm working at it. I'm vigilant toward it. In the words of Baba Chuck, I will say this, you are, as he would say, I am because you are, and because you are, we are. And because you are so great, Hillside will continue to be stellar, magnificent, professional, unending. The legacy will always continue and never die. And your life and longevity in the world of dance is forever. And I God bless you all for your hard work and your ethics. Stay humble, stay vigilant, stay task masters, and continue to do what you do best. And that is dance with sincerity, beauty, passion, and love. God bless you all. Thank you, Mr. Tab, so much for inviting me.
Thank you, Ms. Chanblue. It's amazing to see you and everyone else. This next person needs no major introduction. This is someone who took me under their wings. I can remember back in the Black Nativity days. And he came and he danced with us. He's a product of Hillside Performing Arts and many other great accomplishments. You may have seen him in Kelly Rowland's video, Beyonce video, and other places like that on stage performances, shows, and tours. Ladies and gentlemen, an amazing Hillside alumni, Santron Freeman, are you there?
Santron. Okay, we'll come back to Santron. If he's, we'll come back to Santron.
Can you guys hear me?
Okay, there you go.
Hi, Santron.
Hi. Hey.
Santron, where are you zooming in from?
I'm zooming in from New York right now. And I first want to say thank you for inviting me here. Thank you all. I have so many memories with you, Mr. Tab. I have so many memories with you, Mr. Kason. So many memories with you, Ms. Paula Nunn, and Lisa Wilder. You've all spoken life into me over the years in ways that you may not know, but it helped save my life, literally. So I want to thank you each for the excellence that you all move in, the love that you all move from, and the space that you hold for people to be celebrated and supported. For all of you out there, congratulations on being alive. Congratulations on being drawn to such excellent leaders and teachers and people who really choose to, you know, empower you to be your most amazing selves. And the beautiful thing about it is, you know, no one can tell you who you are. You already know who you are. And that's the gift that you get to show up in every single day. You know, one of the most greatest things I took away from my experience at Hillside from 2000 to 2004 is to value myself. You know, we all see people talk about manifestation and all these wonderful things. But the biggest thing is when we value ourselves and when we write out our vision, when we can see it, when we can feel it, that's how we draw it in. That's how we attract it. So wherever you are, you know, as you're celebrating yourself in 2020 and as you're moving through this adverse time, take it as a launching pad, as the others have spoken on, and really appreciate yourself for coming through and being your most amazing self, because that's what's happening. And you are so supported. I have been able to dance all over the world and travel and do all these amazing things. But the most important thing has been to, you know, keep character as number one, keep my faith as number one, you know, keep my self-love as number one. And you get to do that too from where you are. And again, this is just a space to listen and to take pause and to appreciate yourself and your journey. So I hope that you all are appreciating yourselves and that you all are feeling celebrated, because you deserve it wholeheartedly. Again, this, I can say so many different things, but what I definitely want to make sure is clear is the more we value ourselves, the more we appreciate ourselves and see ourselves, that's how we draw in that same experience out in the world. Dancers, artists, you know, take care of your education in terms of your financial literacy. You know, people who are looking to do this professionally, really, really do some research and know that no one's lane is the way. You have your own way and your own story, and your journey is going to be beautiful and every step of the way. So, you know, all the stories we hear about being a broke artist, that doesn't have to apply to you. You get to create a different experience for yourself. So always stay tuned in to your heart. That is where the truth is, because it's connected to what we come from. And always stay grateful for everything, because it's all a platform for us to really grow and stand on and shine on. And the truth is, you already have it. You've already had it. You were born with it. And it's just something to appreciate and share with the world. So thank you all for having me. I love you, even though we haven't met. And I love you all that I've seen over the years. And I hope we get to do this again. Thank you.
Thank you, Santron. That was amazing. He has a lot of great things to say. So check him out on Instagram if you have it. He always goes on and gives inspirational words and just insightful things to carry on. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the theater program at Hillside celebrates 33 years of excellence under the direction of Mr. Wendell Tabb. Here to present the Class Awards for Theater is none other than Mr. Tabb. Take it away, Tabb.
Thank you, Ms. Lipscomb. It is an honor and a privilege to recognize these outstanding students in drama. This year, our students have made amazing accomplishments in and out of the classroom. I would like to begin honoring students in the classroom from Theater 1, Theater 2, Theater 3, and Theater 4. Honor them in the Drama Club, Most Improved, Special Recognitions for One Voice, and our top two seniors with the highest grade point average. Let us begin with our Outstanding Achievement Award in Theater Class. For Theater 1, it's Michaela Ali, Mason Pickett, Amari Scott, Logan Lewis, and Samuel Scarborough. For Theater 2, we recognize and honor Josiah Harris, Tiana Porti, and Krishan Waden. For Theater 3, we honor and recognize Avanti Appin, Ethan Guillaume, and Zayana Hinton. And in Theater 4, we recognize the work of Disney DeBerry. For Outstanding Service Award in Drama Club, the top four awards go to Kaya Brown, Larry Gill, James DeBerry, and Krishan Waden. For our Most Improved goes to Antoine Frazier and Lanu Richardson. For special recognition in our International Professional Theater Exchange Program, Hillside Drama Premier Traveling Acting Troupe One Voice. Those members include Kaya Brown, Angel Akron, Ethan Guillaume, Zayana Hinton, Kellyanna Jimenez, Mason Pickett, Cameron Sneed, Daryl Thompson, Amaya Tillery, Elijah Waddell, Nasia Williams, and Nalaja Williams. Our top four outstanding service awards for One Voice goes to Kaya Brown, Zayana Hinton, Kellyanna Jimenez, and Nalaja Williams. And our department awards for the top two singers with the highest GPA in theater. For our valedictorian of theater with a grade point average of 4.468 goes to Cameron Sneed. Our salutatorian of theater with a grade point average of 4.0 goes to Disney DeBerry. Our theater and performer art programs have amazing community support locally and around the world. Let's zoom in to our school and community supporters. We're going to zoom in now to our district administration, school board member, community representatives, superintendent, mayor, city council, and county commissioners to give remarks. What do we have out there, Ms. Ackerson?
Oh my goodness, with honor, we will begin with our district superintendent, Mr. Pascal Mubinga. Mr. Mubinga, welcome.
Thank you. What a wonderful opportunity to be able to have a few words here with all the legend here and our future stars that we're going to have in the future. Just wanted to say thank you to Mr. Tab for your leadership and as well as Dr. Logan for leading this school to a level that I never seen before in North Carolina. And I may even brag across the nation. You guys are doing really outstanding job to see these high school student performing at a level that some professional that we have seen before. Thank you, Mr. Tai, for your leadership. Thank you for all you do. And thank you to all the teachers and some of you that's even coming back to be able to connect to this wonderful community. So as a superintendent of this wonderful district, I just want to say thank you. Keep on pressing on. Our students deserve the best, and you are there just trying to give them all they need so they can be successful. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Bazingas. And please let us take this opportunity to congratulate you for being the State Superintendent of the Year. Congratulations, Dr. Mubinga, from all of us at Hillside High School.
Quick correction, Regional Superintendent of the Year. I'm competing for the state. Thank you.
Well, let's claim it. That's we are claiming that. We're going to go ahead and claim that then.
Thank you.
Miss Agaston, who else do we have out there?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome with honor and distinction, Miss Nakia Hardy.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for inviting me. This has just been a celebration. I love the arts. I play clarinet in middle school. I was in band in high school. And so the arts just have a special place in my heart. And to Mr. Tab, the entire staff here, Ms. Haskins was my band director years ago. Just so pleased to see all the great work and just so happy to see our students and the excellent, extraordinary performances from Hillside. You all are talent filled, and congratulations to the class of 2020. The best is yet to come.
Thank you, Dr. Hardy. Thank you for your leadership. Ms. Agaston, who else do we have?
Ladies and gentlemen, a treasure in the Durham community and Hillside High School alumnus, Miss Minnie Fort Brown.
I am, I have to speak. Okay, wait a minute. I can't.
Unmute your mic.
And use it on my phone. I've never done it on my phone. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you now.
All right, you can't see me though, and I'm so excited. Yeah. I'm especially excited. You can see me? Okay, good. I hope I'm looking
good. Yeah, we can see.
As a Hillside graduate, 1967, as Miss Aggerston's teacher, as Anthony Pierce's teacher, as your confidant comrade, as Xavier Mason's board member, I am so excited to be with these students at Hillside High School. You are all brilliant. I want you to know that this COVID-19, this coronavirus is something that's going to set you apart and keep you focused on who you are and where you're going. You know, God has already planned everything in your life. So this too is a part of the plan. And I want you to go forward in it, knowing that it's only going to make you stronger. You are so talented, so brilliant. Your professors have placed you not on a local stage, not on a statewide stage, not on a national stage, but on an international stage. Everybody around the world knows who you are as Hillside High School. You've been to countries that people have only dreamed of going to. Your talent is expressed in so many different ways, in dance, in music, in art, in theater. You are brilliant. And all I want you to do is remember what Zora Neale Hurston said. Jump at the moon, child. Jump at the moon, child. And you will land among the stars. You keep your head to the sky. Whatever you're going to do next year and the years beyond, God is going to be the wind beneath your wings. Know that. I love you. I'm leaving the board, but I'm not leaving you. And so whenever you need me, call me. I love you. Thank you for inviting me. God bless.
Thank you. Thank you for all your work. Thank you for everything that you've done for the city of Durham and beyond. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ms. Aggerston, who else do we have for the students?
All right. Here to say something to the students, we have Mr. Jeffrey Gunter.
So, Celebrity Gunter, where are you?
I am in California, and I rushed to get here. Can you hear me?
We can hear you.
Okay. I rushed to get here because I knew that I wanted to be a part of this. First of all, giving honor to God for having us all here to do this. There is a silver lining, everyone. You know, don't make any excuse for doing what we're doing right now, because it means something in the long run. And not everybody down the line will be able to say, this is what we did for this graduation in 2020. So lift up this event, because it is necessary, and I'm so glad to be here. Congratulations to the class of 2020. Congratulations to everyone who has won awards so far. I have been a soldier for Hillside High since my visit there. And thank you, Wendell Tabb, for extending that invitation to me, because it's meant a lot to myself and a lot of people that I've come in contact with since that visit. To the graduating class, may I say, let your passion take you where God has sent you. As the sign in front of the Temple of Delphi says, know thyself, know who you are, because who you are, nobody else can be. And that is what's going to take you through this journey called the entertainment business. And you don't compete with anybody else. You compete with yourself, because you excel in that competition. So know thyself first and foremost, and be on time for everything that you do. If you see everybody else not coming early, that's their business. You make sure you're there. Be on time. And as I saw when I was there, you know, in North Carolina, the professionalism that you all had as a school and a group and committed artists, it impressed me so much. So I thank you so much for that. Let that professionalism take you into the world, because it doesn't get easier. But because of your background and because of what Mr. Tab has given you and the staff there has given you and the family at Hillside High has given you, you will stand strong and not let anything deter you, okay? Do the work, people. Do the work. So when asked on the drop of a dime, can you do this? Are you able to do this? You rise to the occasion immediately because you have done the work. So step out there, do your best, step in God's light and travel on the journey that he has made for you, because it's yours to get.
Michael Jackson.
Thank you.
Right. Thank you, Mr. Anderson Gunter. And most of y'all will remember him. I always say this, and he's done so many things, but in the Michael Jackson video, Black and White, I will never forget that look. So thank you so much for all that you're doing, and thank you for zooming in from California. We're gonna do two more, and I got a few more, because we wanna give out some more big awards that are coming for the students, but we want this to be inspirational for them as well. So Ms. Axel, let's do two more, and then we'll do some awards, and then come back.
Yes, sir, absolutely. Zooming to us live is our DPS, District Arts Director, our leader, Mr. Jeremy Tucker.
Hello, everybody, students and teachers. We are so, 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 so proud of all of you and your accomplishments. You know, most students that are seniors will graduate in the next couple of weeks, but you all out there are not most students. And so I think that you students have gone above and beyond by pursuing courses in arts education during your high school career. Whether you're a performer or whether you plan on being a supporter, we celebrate you tonight. This is one of the most challenging times our world has ever seen. The arts have taught us and have taught you how to respond. Response through dance, through movement, through visual arts, through theater arts, spoken words, singing, using voice. You are the best students and we have the best teachers. So I have to say a quick congratulations to our arts educators for your leadership and your dedication to each of your students. And of course, Dr. Logan, for being a principal that we can all count on to support a well-rounded education that includes the arts. Bravo to all of you. Thank you so much.
So much. Ms. Agerson, if you would allow me to introduce this last one before we go to awards, and then we're going to come back and introduce everyone else. Just hold tight, guys, because this is amazing. But I do want to introduce a celebrity that's coming in now, zooming in with us from California. This celebrity needs no introduction, but a lot of people may remember him from All My Children. I used to come home from school and I would watch All My Children, and watching Jesse and Angie on All My Children. So please, let's welcome Darnell Williams, who played Jesse on All My Children, zooming in from California. Darnell. Darnell, are you there? Okay, so we're gonna now move from Darnell. We'll come back to Darnell. And let's go now to Pierce Freelon, and then we'll go to awards. Mr. Freelon?
Yeah, I'm here. What's up?
Hi. Hey, how you doing?
First, let's
set this up for you. I want to thank you so much for being here.
Come on.
Every day that all of us walk through this building, you know that your dad has a place in all of our hearts.
Mm.
Freelon's father designed Hillside High School. So as we walk through, just know that your family is with us every single day. So thank you all for being a wonderful family. Thank you for all that you're doing. And thank you for having One Voice to perform at your place as well. So Mr. Freelon, thank you. Take it away.
Well, thank you for bringing up my dad. I was going to mention him, because not only my father designed Hillside, but he also designed the National Museum of African American History and Culture. And I think that's That's really important for y'all, Hillside Hornets. We are so proud of you. And I want you to know that your career, it may start here in Durham, but there is no limit. There is no limit to how far you can go. And you know, it was a big deal for my dad when he got the Hillside Project, this historic school that has meant so much to the city of Durham, where I was born and raised. And, you know, if he didn't get Hillside as a project, as an architect, he would not have been able to level up to the Stone Center in Chapel Hill. He would not have been able to level up all the way to Washington, D.C. So that's my message to y'all, is bloom where you're planted. That's what my grandma used to say to me. You know, keep working, nurture your gifts. It starts as a seed, a small seed. You plant that in the ground. You stay humble, like Miss Chimflu, my African dance teacher from high school used to say. You start with that seed and you water it every day. We expect excellence from you, but we know that that excellence won't come overnight. You keep working hard, it will lead to opportunities and success. So thank you very much, Mr. Tab, for having me. Congratulations, graduates. And I've been following all these speakers on Instagram. Everybody's so inspirational. So make sure you check me out on the gram too. I will follow y'all back, students. And thank you for letting me be a part of this distinguished panel of speakers. Everybody in here has been so wonderful and inspiring to listen to.
Thank you very much, Mr. Freelon. Tonight, we're live on Facebook and we are live on YouTube. Share the news on all your social media by using hashtag HillsideVPA2020. It's a photo shoot, take a selfie, and capture your favorite highlights from tonight's event. We thank you for your continued support of Hillside High School Performing Arts. We had an amazing production of The Bodyguard, where we had celebrity guest Mr. Bill Cobbs, who played the role of Bill Devaney in the original movie starring the late Whitney Houston. Let's go to the highlight reel to see what those students were all about in The Bodyguard. Take a look.
He keeps muting you.
It's not him.
No, the host
the same way I always have.
Devaney, we've got
you on show.
Look, I'm gonna tell you something.
going to do whatever show I want, and I'm going to eat wherever I want.
That's what I do.
Did I do something wrong?
No, it was me. I'm the one that screwed up.
Do you want me to beg?
No, I want you to do without.
What is this, Frank?
I can't protect you this way.
Just tell me what I did.
You did nothing. I'm the one that made the mistake.
You mean me? I'm a mistake?
Christ, I told
you. And what? That's it for me?
You can either live with it or fire me.
But I can't be with you. Fine.
Rachel, listen to me.
I said fine! You told me the situation. What are you gonna do now? Talk about it? Get out, Frank. Get out!
That is so amazing, The Bodyguard. I wish I could award every student in The Bodyguard. The cast and crew of The Bodyguard were absolutely amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, here are the top awards for The Bodyguard. I will first introduce you for Best Supporting Performer in The Bodyguard. For Best Supporting Actor in The Bodyguard is Elijah Wadding. For Best Supporting Actress in The Bodyguard, Zayana Hinton. For Best Supporting Dancer, Bob Burns. For Best Supporting Vocalist, Zayana Hinton. For Best Supporting Pit Vocalist, Angela Holmes. For Best Supporting Technician or Staff Member, Kellyanna Jimenez. For Best Supporting Stage Crew or Staff, De'Erica Spruill. And now for the best performance in The Bodyguard, for best actor in The Bodyguard, Krishan Whedon. For best actress in The Bodyguard, Nasia Williams. For best dancer, Brooklyn Evans. Best vocalist, Nasia Williams. Best pit vocalist, Myasia Chambers. Best staff, Nalija Williams. And for best stage crew or staff, Larry Gill. For the 7 honorable mentions in acting, and there was a cast of nearly 100 students. For the top 7 honorable mention in acting, Daryl Thompson, Ethan Guillaume, Amari Scott, Mason Pickett, Josiah Harris, Josiah Jennings, and Taylor Brown. For honorable mention in dance, dance, your top two, Kalia Green and Ariana Young. We know that our performing arts students are loved all over the world. So, Ms. Agerston, let's see where the love is coming from.
Absolutely, Mr. Tapp. Zooming in live right now, our very own and beloved Miss Starletta Dupois.
This is technology for you. So we'll come back to Starletta. Who else do we have on the Zoom line, Ms. Agerston?
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Biff Henderson.
Mr. Henderson, you're going to have to
do what?
There you go. All right, let me introduce him.
Okay.
Biff Henderson is a graduate of Hillside High School. He was the stage manager for the David Letterman Show. So, celebrity Biff Henderson, we welcome you back to Hillside High School. Mr. Henderson.
Thank you very much, Mr. Tabbs, and congratulations to you and the name of the theater after yourself and Mr. Gaddis. I grew up in Durham at the old Hillside, and I finished Hillside in 1962. Actually, for those of you from Durham that don't know, there's a building on Duke Street named after my father, the Henderson Towers. But I just wanted to take this moment. I thank you for this. I was there about a year or so ago, Mr. Tabbs, and others invited me down to be honored, and that with the Sween School project, and it was excellent. So I just want to congratulate the graduates of 2020. And looking at myself on this thing, I'm glad it took the coronavirus for me to realize I could grow hair. I didn't realize it for a moment there, you know? So having said that, I just want to congratulate everyone and just realize in an entertainment business, it's all about endurance. It's about temporary work and rejection and things like that. But don't ever forget from which you came, meaning Hillside, and the words of the school song. You know, when it says, our hearts are gleeful, filled with joy and sorrow. Our memories will linger always. Three cheers for Hillside High. Don't ever forget that. Keep it in your mind. And one of the things I said when I accepted the award at Hillside last February, a year ago, I said, you know, you may not be able to determine the direction of the wind, but you can certainly adjust your sails to reach your destination. So congratulations to everyone here and to all the graduates, and keep up the good work and go forward.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Henderson. Thank you for all that work. I love watching you as a stage manager on the David Letterman Show. And I was like, well, my kids can do that, because here's a Hillside graduate that's doing stage. Thank you very much.
Let's understand one thing. People used to always ask me, they said, well, Biff, aren't you nervous when you're on television? I said, what is there to be nervous about when you really don't know what you're doing?
All right. Well, thank you, Mr. Henderson. Miss Agerston, you want to try it again? I think Starletta may be there. Want to introduce her again?
Absolutely. Ladies and gentlemen, our very own Auntie Starletta.
She just texted me to say that she's on now. So, okay, she says she's having problems with her audio. So we'll keep it moving until she gets hers all worked out. Let's keep moving now. I saw Zach Hawkins, and I know he's want to get him in. So, Mr. Hawkins, are you still there? He may have to go back to another meeting. So we'll keep it. We'll keep it. Mr. Hawkins, thank you so
much. Yeah, I'm right here.
All right, here's Representative Hawkins. Thank you so very much, representing the state of North Carolina and Durham. So take it away.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much for the opportunity. Congratulations to our graduates. It is it's amazing that you've been able to not only make it this far, but you made it through a global pandemic. And so you should be absolutely, you know, proud of yourself. I'm a huge fan of your work. I've had a chance to enjoy and sit in the crowd, and I'm absolutely amazed. I think one of the speakers talked about your professionalism, but I'm just talking about your ability and your talent. I can't wait to see so many of you on the stage, live and performing, and carrying out your dreams, because you definitely have the talent. One thing that I'll tell you, if you can make it in Durham, if you can make it at Hillside, you can make it anywhere. And I want you absolutely to believe that. But a couple things that I will absolutely leave you with is to take your craft seriously. Take it absolutely seriously, because if you do, everybody else does. One of the things that you may have watched, if you watched The Last Dance, Michael Jordan said he always played on 10, always, because, you know, he had a respect for the game and a respect for what it did for other people. Because every time you step out on stage, every time you perform, somebody will be seeing you for the first time, and they need to see your best. They need to know exactly how good you are and that you're believing and leading up to the hype. The other things that I'll say you are just about leadership in general. Integrity is still important. Do the right thing when nobody's looking. Make sure that you're accountable and holding people accountable. Because if you don't hold people accountable, they'll always try to, you know, get over on you. But also keep yourself accountable so that you can get up and have the discipline to do well. And then be emotionally intelligent. You know that somebody's not okay and know exactly what to say and when to say it. That's important, because in these times, as you know, sometimes people aren't okay. And sometimes people will be having a bad day in the future. And I really want to make sure that you have other people in mind, that you're empathetic, and that we're producing students who care about other people. But most importantly, have fun, guys. This is the best time of your life. You're resilient, you're strong, and you're strategic, you're hardworking. And again, you're from Durham. And so I want to congratulate you. I'm your state representative, and if there's anything I can do for you and your family, please let me know. Thank you, Mr. Tabb, for your leadership and making this program exactly what it is. But I am so proud of you. Go Hillside, go Hornets. Congratulations.
All right. Thank you so very much. The students are waiting for some more awards, so we're going to have to go to the awards, because this program is all about them. And so, Ms. Agerson, we'll bring Tara Scott in right after you do these next awards, okay? And so let's go. Let's give out some more awards. I present to you Ms. Tiffany Agerson for Chorus. Take it away, Tiffany.
Absolutely, Mr. Tabb. This year at our concert, we honored the legacy of Hillside High School's chorus teachers. Tonight, we recognize our outstanding student performers from that chorus concert entitled Seven Trails. Those awards are as follows. Best Tribute Performance, Hold On, A Change Is Coming, Full Ensemble. Best Solo Performance, Volver, Volver, Denexi Nunes. Best Duo or Group, The Gospel Medley, My Asia Chamber, Zayana Hinton and Tamaya Waiting. Best Choreography, Proud Mary, Angela Holmes, Jordan Burton, and Janiyah Rogers. Excellence in Narration, Miss Julicia Robertson. Honorable Mentions in Performance, Don't Worry, Denasia Gilba. Hold On, A Change Is Coming, Robert Johnson and Tanaya Ray. You're All I Need to Get By, Disney DeBerry and Antoine Frazier. Best Stage Performance, Remember the Time. Also, honorable mention in narration, Miss Keani Green and Tony Davis. And best ensemble number, Georgia On My Mind, from the full ensemble. A special thank you to Drama Club and One Voice for technical support, the Collective Groove Band, Mr. Kinsby Blunt, Mr. Cameron Morgan, and Mr. Antoine Timmons, Miss Lipscomb for costuming, parents for hospitality, documentary guests, sound, lighting, and videography. You all have worked so very hard, and I am proud of you. This special recognition is dedicated to the ladies of Vocal Pit Ensemble. These girls opened up the production of The Bodyguard with show-stopping vocal talent. Tonight, we honor Nakaya Atkins, Kayla Atkins, Kyra Butler, Chelsea Caldwell, Myasia Chambers, Paja Clemens, Ariana Gray, Trinity Harris, Ziana Hinton, Angela Holmes, and Tamaya Waden. Ladies, thank you for your gifts, dedication, and beautiful personalities. You are very special to us, and we honor you. Our next recognitions go to the Hornet Harmony Glee Club. Since its inception in 2017, the Glee Club has rocked the community with amazing creativity and astounding voices. From competitions to late nights, early mornings, and far travels, Glee Club has been a big part of our musical experience. Tonight, we honor Avanti Akpin, Taylor Brown, Kyra Butler, Disney DeBerry, James DeBerry, Antoine Frazier, Ethan Guillaume, Ziana Hinton, Angela Holmes, Yasmin Laster, Savion Robinson, Krishan Waden, and Tamaya Waden. Glee, thank you for being an amazing group. Continue to use your gifts to inspire others. We love and appreciate you, and I honor you. I can't forget about our all-county participants. Kayla Atkins, Myasia Chambers, Paja Clemens, Angela Holmes, Kamora Jones, Michael Sneed, Olivia Taylor, and Tamaya Waden. Our MPA Festival singers, Tyvel Brody, Ayansi Craig Brown, Tony Davis, Janaya Hardy, Luis Luarte, Savion Robinson, Kiara Yeager, Kayla Atwater, Chelsea Caldwell, and Jadira Hicks. Students, you constantly amaze me with your gifts and talents. Thank you for an awesome year. When I come back, I will be presenting the final awards for Hillside High School Chorus. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our special vocal guest. You may know her best as Mary from Black Nativity. Please welcome Miss Tyra Scott.
Hi, guys. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Hey, Tara.
Okay, wonderful. So I'm here with my dad, and we're going to do a song that's been on my heart for a few weeks now. And again, congratulations to the class of 2020. I'm very proud of you for making it through this very difficult time. And I hope that this song speaks to you as much as it speaks to me. Tragedies are commonplace. All kinds of diseases, people are slipping away. Economy is down, people can't get enough pay. But as for me, all I can say is thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Without homes, living out in the street, and the drug habits, some say they just can't beat. Mothers and robbers, no place seems to be safe. But you've been my protection every step of the way, and I wanna say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. It could have been me outdoors with no food and no clothes, or left alone without a friend, or just another number with some tragic end. But you didn't see fit to let any of these things be, 'cause every day by your power you keep on keeping me. And I wanna say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Oh, could have been left alone without a single friend, or just another number with some tragic end. But you didn't see a fit to let any of these things be. Every day by your power,
keep on, keep on keeping me. And I want to say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. I want to thank you for your love. Thank you for your power, for your protection. Every hour, I want to thank you for your love. Thank you for your power, for your protection. Every hour, I want to thank you for your love and your power, your protection. Every hour. And I want to say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me.
Wow. Thank you so much, Tara. Oh, you are such an amazing talent. Thank you for blessing Hillside High School. Thank you for blessing our students. We are going to move really quickly through the program. So as you all are speaking now, we're going to have to keep some of the conversations a little shorter so that we can move right on through. So we're on a time limit. But this is so important and it's so inspirational. I don't want to make sure anybody is shorter, but we got to get through the program. But y'all are saying some powerful stuff for the students. And so I just can't thank you enough. But now we're going to go to Donnell Williams, California. Donnell, are you there? I don't know what it is with California. I'm just kidding. Donnell, are you there? Okay. So we're going to go now to Auntie Starletta again. They're texting me saying that they're having audio problems. Auntie Starletta, you want to try it? So this is what, Dr. Logan, this is what teaching is going to be like if we don't come back to school. So, all right. So let's now move to a couple of our graduates before we move on. I see Ron McGill is on the line. I see that Joshua Johnson is on the line. And then we'll go to another celebrity. Okay, Ron McGill. Come on in, unmute please, and come on in.
Hi, can everyone hear me?
Yes.
We're good? Okay. Hey, thank y'all first and foremost. Thank you so very much, Mr. Tab. Thank you, everyone, and I'm so glad to see everyone here. It's been a while. I graduated in 2005. Real quick, I remember the first time I walked into a theater class, Mr. Tab, the first thing you said to me was, hey, I hope you know this is advanced theater, this is theater 4. And I was like, all right, let's go. But that is just but that's just the cloth that we're cut from. And I just want everyone to know, students, class of 2020, that there is a cloth that you were cut from. There is a hunger. There is a passion that we have coming from Hillside. And I'm so glad and so proud to be able to go as far as I've gone thus far in my career and, you know, continue to go. And I encourage all of you. I'm doing things that I learned when I was in your position, and I want y'all to know that this is possible and great things are ahead. And I just want y'all to stay focused and stay within that passion and just know that the love that you are experiencing right now on stage, that is what is going to get you through. And I just want to let y'all know, congratulations. So proud of y'all. I do tend to ramble, so I'm gonna cut it short. All right. Thank you so very much.
Thank you, Ron. And we always are proud of your role that you had on Grey's Anatomy. So thank you for all the work that you are doing. We love what you're doing in acting. And I know that you were on tour with your play as well. You and Rasheem Shabazz, another graduate.
Yes. So we met here. Yeah, absolutely.
All right. Is he on the line?
I don't know if he is, but yeah, he's here in spirit. He's here in spirit.
Right. Okay. Well, congratulations on all the work that y'all are doing.
Thank you. Thank you so very much, Mr. Thank you.
Thank you. Let's go over to Joshua Johnson.
Well, hello, Mr. Tam. Hi, everyone. It is so great to be in the room with so many great people on this screen, just my screen. I'm seeing people like Miss Wilder, Mr. Kasem, Miss Lacewell, like great people that have brought me to the place where I am now. Start to love on the people that brought you to the place where you are. If Mr. Kasem and Mr. Tab hadn't given me the opportunity to write a song for Mufaro's Beautiful Daughters, I don't know where I would have been. And I don't know if I would have even tried to write now. And I'm in my third year of teaching. I said I was never going to teach. And I had to come back and apologize to the four of y'all for some of the things that I probably put you through. But I love y'all so dearly. I love everybody. It's so great to see friends of mine, Ron McGill, Santron Freeman. Every time I look on the screen, brother, I'm excited to see you doing this because you make it possible for me. You make it possible for them and these students. I hope y'all are somewhere taking some notes about such great things that you've heard on this call. But the one great thing that I want to leave y'all is don't ever take no for an answer. You never know where there might be an open door. So if you stop at that one no, you'll never see what God has for you through this journey. It's always a journey to where he's trying to get you. Like I said, never knew that I was going to be a teacher, never knew I was going to be doing exactly the same thing that Mr. Tab put me through, never knew that I would be known for my keys like he is known for dropping his keys on the stage. But I am so humbled to be asked to be a part of this. Know that y'all are so very talented. I came and I was in awe, and my kids were in awe at Color Purple. When I came to see the Bodyguard, I was still in awe. I tried to recruit some kids. I'm sorry, I did try to take some of y'all's kids because y'all are so super duper talented. Do not let your light go out for anybody. Continue to let your light shine. I thank you again for this time.
Thank you very much. So we're gonna go to three quick celebrities because they're gonna zoom in, they're gonna zoom right back out, and then we're gonna go right back to some more awards. Let's zoom in for North Carolina's local celebrity. Let's go to ABC 11 News, Tim Pullum. Tim, are you there?
I am here, Mr. Tab. Hello, everybody. It's so good to see you guys, so many familiar faces coming to you from the Bull City. To the graduates, I just want to say continue to grow your skills and talents. I have been a television news reporter for 15 years, and I can tell you that I have gotten much better and confident and comfortable in my craft as I've worked towards it. So continue to do that. You will receive a lot of no's in entertainment and television news, but all you need is one yes to pursue your dreams, and never reduce who you are to make someone else feel comfortable. Be proud of who you are and reach for the stars. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. And thank you for the work that you are doing on television. We love listening to you. We love watching you. Thank you for supporting all the projects. We really appreciate it. So thank you. And please, tell Tisha Power, Mr. Taft said hello, and Joel Brown. Thank you so much. Now we also have on the line, we're going to zoom in, Ms. Agaston. Let's go back to Darnell Williams now from Jesse from All My Children. Darnell, are you there? We're having a hard time getting Darnell. So let's go to Antonio Fargas, better known from the show, playing Huggy Bear.
Hey, everybody, are you there?
Yeah, we just can't see you.
That's it. Can you see me?
We can hear you. There we go.
Good evening.
Then you went away. Right, there you go.
Good evening, everybody. This is amazing, amazing
amazing evening. I just wanted to add my zooming in from Las Vegas. I was blown away when I came to Durham and went to Hillside to see The Color Purple. I was invited by Auntie Stella Dubois, and I am so convinced that what you're doing, Wendell, and what these students have achieved is just truly amazing. To see the talent, to see the dedication that these young people have, and also taking the advantage of the opportunities that you know, what people talked about, you'll have a lot of doors that will be closed, but a door closed is an opportunity for another one to be opened. All talking about the love that's invested in each student by you, Wendell, and all the people that are associated with Hillside High School. It's just truly an amazing, amazing event. And I just want to tell these young people that just continue on, stay strong, believe in the love that you have and where you came from, and know the shoulders that you stand on, and know that you're making your shoulders strong for someone else to stand on. Congratulations to the seniors, and I just appreciate everything that you're doing there in Durham, and thank you for the opportunity to be with you tonight. I even wore a little bit of blue and white because it's so special. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you for the celebrity, Antonio Fargas. We really appreciate you. Now we're gonna go, let's introduce Casey so we can get back on script, Tiffany.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a Hillside High School superstar zooming in from Atlanta, Georgia. Representing the class of 2006, she is a choir legend, Miss Casey McCall Moore. Take it away, Casey.
Sometimes it feels cold and you feel all alone. Hold on, better days are coming. It can be rough in this world. I know it ain't easy, but hang on in there. I know better days are coming. You sing good, you sing bad, you've been happy and sad. But just remember that better days are coming. All by yourself, but don't cry, 'cause better days are coming. Better days, better days. It's only a season that you're going through, hey, yeah. But stay focused and never lose sight.
coming. Thank y'all so much.
Thank you. Thank you, KC. Stay safe in Atlanta. All right. Miss Agerston, on you.
Beautiful talent continues to shine through our alumni. Casey, we honor you and we thank you. And now, to present the awards for band, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Sybil Haskins.
Thank you, Miss Agerston. We want to congratulate the immortal Sting on their accomplishments during the short but sweet 2020-21 season. We are excited to have been nominated for Marching Band of the Year for the second consecutive time and are keeping our fingers crossed as we await the results. I would like to take the time to highlight our students who are continuing to participate in band on a university level, four of which who are on a band scholarship: Tyree Strickland, Dylan Smoke, Ryan Hewitt, Taylor Ashley, Cameron Kelly, Ashley Weeks, Nadia Bennett, and Zamaria Patterson. Students, I thank you for your dedication and leadership in the band. When I return, I'll be presenting the final top awards for band leadership. Here to present the awards for dance, once again, Miss Valencia Lipscomb.
Hello, hello. Thank you, Miss Haskins. Hillside Performing Arts is the topic of discussion. Capture the moment by using hashtag HillsideVPA2020. Get in on the action. Don't forget your selfies. Everyone can get in on the fun. Tonight, we will honor our award-winning dancers furthermore. The first category will be Outstanding Dancer. This award goes to students that exhibit hard work, dedication, and team spirit, doing their very best to be the best dancer that they can be. Blood, sweat, and tears. Being a good dancer is easy. Simply doing a dance is easier. But to be outstanding means to stand above the rest, especially in moments when the spotlight isn't on you. So, for my Outstanding Dancer Award, they will go to Kalia Green, Sierra Solomon, Diamond Dudley, Morgan Comer, Sanaa Marshall, Daphne Chinflu, Jocelyn Couch, Sanaya McCall, Kanisha Harvey, and Jay Scott Kirkland. Wonderful job, ladies. And then now it's a special part that's dear to me, Miss A, Mr. Tab, and the rest of the administration and staff at Hillside know that none of our jobs would be possible without our parents. So I want to give out a few awards to my amazing parents. First, the Service Award. These parents do as much as they can with their busy and hectic schedules to make it to the kids' shows, to help me when I need a little bit of help, and just to be there for their support. I would like to award Mrs. Valerie Warren, Kim Young, Miss Kim, I call her Mom Kim, and Tammy Marshall, and also a new parent we have on board, Sincera Phillips McCall. Thank you, amazing. Next, I will have my MVP, Most Valuable Parent. This award goes to parents that do go above and beyond. They bring the kids food, they do carpool. Anytime I ask, anytime I need, they are there. If the times are off, they're there to wait around. Thank you. I want to give those awards to Mrs. Harriet Davis and Ms. Maria Green. And finally, for my Mom of the Year Award, I got two winners for that one. And this one is for the parents that spend time on the clock and off with me. So getting everything organized, costumes, field trips, and everything like that, I just want to honor Tawanda Metz and Mrs. Angela Tucker Young. Thank you, ladies, so much. I don't know what I would do without all of you. Students, I thank you for all of your talents and commitment to Hillside High School Dance once again. When I return, I will be presenting the final top awards that we all want to see in dance leadership, dance of the year, and even my captain for next year. But now, I want to welcome back our favorite, our hearts, Mr. Wendell Tabb.
Thank you, Miss Lipskin. You are so wonderful. Our second production of the season was backed by popular demand, honoring the legacy of Mr. John H. Gaddis with Mr. G's Swing School with our production of Hallelujah Swing School. Let's go to the highlight reel because these students love looking at themselves. So let's go. Hallelujah Swing School. Take a look.
Let's Sit back, relax, and enjoy Hallelujah Swing School.
Peace.
Wow. Hallelujah Swing School. I wish I could have worked with a student in Hallelujah Swing School. Their commitment to writing an original script was beyond amazing. I know that the legacy of Mr. John Gaddis continues with these students. Here are the top Academy Awards for Hallelujah Swing School. I will begin with Best Supporting Performance in Hallelujah Swing School. For Best Supporting Actor, that award goes to James. For Best Supporting Actress in Hallelujah Swing School, that award goes to Avante Appin. For Best Supporting Dancer, Janiyah Mormon. For Best Supporting Vocalist, Avante Appin. For Best Supporting Pit Vocalist, Ariana Gray. For Best Supporting Technician or Staff, Nalijah Williams. For Best Supporting Stage Crew or Staff, Josiah Tatum. Now for the awards for Best Performance in Hallelujah Swing School. The Best Actor Award for Hallelujah Swing School goes to Ethan Guillon. For Best Actress in Hallelujah Swing School goes to Kaya Brown. Best Dancer, Makai Burns. Best Vocalist, Zayana Henson. Best Pit Vocalist, Tamia Waden. For Best Technician or Staff, Mason Pickett. For Best Stage or Staff, Krishan Waden. The 7 honorable mentions in acting for Hallelujah Swing School, the top 7 award goes to Angel Akram, Amaya Tillery, Zadira Reyes, De'Erica Spruill, Taylor Brown, and Alima Shaw. And Tatiana Porti, for your honorable mention in dance, the top 2 awards go to Sierra Solomon and Jada Scott Kirkland. For honorable mention in vocals, Nicaea Williams and Amaya Tillery. Now I will present your Creative Arts Awards. For Outstanding Creativity as a Performer, James D. Berry. For Outstanding Creativity as a Writer, Nalijah Williams and Angel Akram. For Outstanding Creativity as a Technician, Mason Pickett. Your Most Promising Newcomer Award, this would be a freshman, Anaya Lowe. Most Promising Award as a Talented Actress, Diana Porti. Most Promising as a Double Threat is as an actress and a singer is Zayana Hinton. Your Double Threat as an actress and a singer, De'Erica Spruill. Your Most Promising as an Actor and a Singer is Ethan Guillon. Your Double Threat as an Actress and a Singer, Avante Appin. Most Promising Award as a Set Builder and a Performer, Krishan Waden. Most Promising Award as a Triple Threat, Actor, Singer, Dancer, Daryl Thompson. Most Promising Award as an Actress, Singer, Nicaea Williams. A Triple Threat, Most Promising Award as an Actress, Director, and Producer, Kaya Brown. Now for the Stage Manager and Director's Leadership Awards. These are 6 top awards. They go to Amaya Tillery, Eliana Jimenez, Nalijah Williams, Nicaea Williams, Zayana Hinton, and Kaya Brown. We know that our alumni love Hillside Performing Arts. Let's zoom in from all over the world again and see what our alumni are up to. Let's zoom in to the SS Renaissance. Ms. Agerson, take it away.
SS Renaissance, tonight we welcome Miss Julia Fairley, Miss Claudine Day Lewis, and Miss Audrey Boykin. Welcome.
Miss Fairley, you're going to be the spokesperson? You have to unmute. Ms. Fairley, you have to unmute. Thank you.
Good evening. On behalf of the board members of SS Renaissance, all of whom who are here tonight, except Ms. Fern Dixon and Mr. George Scott, it is a great pleasure for us to congratulate Mr. Tab, the members of, Mr. Scott is here. Thank you, Mr. Scott, for being here. And we just congratulate everybody for giving us the opportunity to take a walk back into our history with Swing School. We are also so honored to have had a hand in facilitating the naming of the theater, the John Gaddis Wendell Tabb Theater, and the stage, the Wendell Tabb Stage. It's a pleasure for us to have done that. And we thank we thank Dr. Logan for all the times that he worked with us and the entire Hillside and Durham community who helped us to make this a possibility. Students, you are amazing. And we're going, those people who tried to steer Mr. Tabb away from us, we're gonna try to keep Mr. Tabb here in this area because he is an amazing teacher. And all you have to do is to remember the fantastic teachers that you've had in the Performing Arts Department, and you cannot lose. Thank you.
Ms. Fairley and SS Renaissance team, all of you, thank you all so very much. And I'll be remiss to not congratulate all of you all have done for Hillside, especially Hillside Theater. Thank you for the $13,000 that you all donated to Hillside Theater. I cannot thank you enough. That is amazing. Anybody that's in theater in the world, when you get a contribution like that at one time from an organization, I just dropped to the floor. So thank you all so very much. And for all the rest of the alumni out there, match what the SS Renaissance did for Hillside. Y'all are making big money. Come on, give that some of that money back to Hillside High School. So thank you all so very much. I'm so appreciative. Again, thank you for everything that you all have done. Ms. Ackerson, who else is out there zooming in?
Also on the line, we have, surprise, surprise, Kristen McCauley, Jonathan Bethay, and Veronique. Welcome.
All right, let's go to Kristen. Where is Kristen McCauley? Where are you zooming in from?
I'm zooming in from Atlanta, Georgia, and I just wanted to say that I'm so excited to be a part of the Hillside family. Hillside Performing Arts has done so much for me. I've had the opportunity to go places and experience things that I never thought that I would be able to do. And I got that foundation from Hillside. And to the class of 2020, I know we want to be brief. I just want to say, don't let detours be stop signs for you. Keep pressing forward, go out and make a difference and change the world. And congratulations to you, Mr. Tabb, for enduring so many years and depositing so many positive things into the students at Hillside. Thanks.
But thank you for all your wonderful talents that you gave to Hillside High School, and you took those talents and continued. So thank you so very much. Please give your family much love from us as well.
I will.
Who are we going to, Ms. Ackerson?
Jonathan Bethay, please welcome Jonathan Bethay. Are you here with us?
Hello, y'all can hear me? Hello?
Yes, Jonathan, where are you zooming in from?
I'm currently in New York City in the middle of the pandemic, but we're all hanging in there. I'm going to try and keep it brief. It's been a long time since I graduated, but I'm so thankful for all of the memories that I've had at Hillside. And I wanted to share to those graduating that the memories that you have now will last you a lifetime. Just retain that, pay it forward to the next generation. Come back, continue to support Hillside, continue to support your peers, spread the love. This world needs more of it. That's my piece. God bless you all. I'm so thankful to be here.
Thank you, Jonathan. Jonathan is a director and producer in New York. He's doing off-Broadway shows. He has his own work that he's doing in New York. So Jonathan, thank you for keeping that legacy of Hillside going and you keeping it going right there in New York City. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, sir.
Tiffany, where are we going?
Next up, we have Veronique. Veronique, are you here with us?
Veronique there?
I am not sure if you can hear me. I have no voice, but I wanted to tune in with you all tonight.
Hi.
We can hear you.
Okay, I'm going to try to keep it short and sweet. First of all, I'm just very honored to be able to sign in and to see this and to be able to give a few moments to give back just everything that Mr. Tabb and the Performing Arts Department, Ms. Nunn, Ms. Wilder, Mr. Kaysen imparted in me. I continue today and it's been a blessing and it's been the foundation for my career. I celebrated my 20-year graduation from Hillside on yesterday. But what I just want to share with the students, it's really important. Just pay close attention to your dreams. I really believe that they're letters from God to you, and those talents and gifts that you possess, they're meant to be a voice that resonates throughout the world. So as you continue and wherever you go, do not lose that. Know that your presence and your voice and your talents and your gifts were created with a purpose, and that you're beautiful, you're handsome, you're gifted, you're magical, you are powerful, and don't let anything or anyone allow you to forget that. It is amazing to continue to see you do all that you do. A few years ago, when I was an intern teacher for a private academy, I was able to come see High School Musical, and the students were in awe. I'm currently hanging out for the pandemic back home in the Bull City because I am offset in New York. So it's good to be back home, and I'm going to just send you continual love and light. And it's just amazing to continue to see what you all are doing. So thank you for continuing the legacy.
Thank you, Veronique. Veronique is a triple threat. Veronique is not only a producer and director and an actress, but Veronique taught herself how to run the lights here at Hillside. So that's what we do. So thank you, Veronique, for all that you're doing. And when you go back to New York, please be safe.
I will. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Ms. Agerson, where are we zooming into?
Next, we have, oh my goodness, legendary dream girl, Lindsay Hannah, and a former stage manager, Miss Simone Cruz.
Lindsay.
Hi, I am zooming in from New Orleans, Louisiana, and I'm super excited to be on here. I've just been filled with so many emotions just replaying this and remembering myself in those shoes. And first things first, I just want to say as an educator to the students on here that I'm super proud of you for just tasking it and taking the call to get through this during a pandemic with remote learning. But as you enter into the real world, just know that it's most important to be yourself because you're the best person and the only person who can do that. And continue to tackle everything in life with grace, effervescence, poise, and most of all, grit. Hillside Drama Department has taught you a lot of those things. It's taught you discipline. That's one of the most important things that you're gonna take into the real world, as we call it. And it's also taught you the importance of being confident in everything you do. So just continue to take all of that, continue to keep the relationships that you built. I still have strong relationships with my best friends who I met through the drama department. So making sure that you're just being the best version, giving yourself grace. And if you do stumble, just make sure that you're recovering and doing it for you and nobody else.
Thank you. And you're zooming in from where?
New Orleans, Louisiana.
Okay, thank you for zooming in from around the world. They're coming in from everywhere. Ms. One more before we go back to the lab, to the final awards.
All right, Mr. Tam, on the line we have Simone Cruz. Simone, welcome.
Hi, everybody. Congratulations. I know that the past couple of months have been very rough. I live in Los Angeles, California, where I'm working at a talent agency. And currently I'm in Durham. I decided to come home and wait out the storm. What I want to say is what everybody has said a little bit, which is you're more than prepared. When you go out and you compete, people are going to be stunned by your professionalism, your discipline, how much you actually know, even though you may not know all the technical terms. Everywhere and every step I've taken, everybody's always been so blown away. And I've always said it's because of Mr. Tab and the whole staff at Hillside. That has prepared me for where I am. So you can do it. Don't let no deter you. There are many, many positions and different angles you can get into this entertainment industry through. So congratulations again.
Thank you. Do we want to take one more? Because we're going to go to the final awards. Ms. Agassi, you want to take one more? Do we have another one?
Absolutely. I would like to welcome, of course, former alumni. We just heard her beautiful voice, Mrs. Casey McCall Moore.
Hey guys, I just want to say congratulations to everyone. I take this as a privilege and an honor during this pandemic. It definitely is something that we all have to get used to. Being an essential worker, I definitely see this every day. And I just want everybody to stay safe. And congratulations to everyone. And thank you again for having me. I love each and every one of you. Hey, Dr. Logan.
and Mr. Kaysen, and who else on here? Hey, Ms. Brown, good to see you too. And I love each and every one of you guys, and I miss y'all so, so much. I'll see y'all in December. This is going to be over because Black Nativity has to happen. Had to drop the plug.
Right, Black Nativity. Thank you very much. Thank you, Casey.
You're welcome.
All right. This is so exciting. We're gonna have only one more opportunity for the Zoom in. So right now, for all of you that's Zooming in from all over the world, thank you so very much. We'll have one more time because I want to try to get Darnell Williams in. He's still on the line trying to get in, so I want to get him in. And Auntie Starletta is still trying to get in as well. But thank you all so very much. But it's not over yet. When I return, I will be giving out the final awards for Freshman of the Year, Best Actor and Actress of the Year, Performing Artist of the Year, the John H. Gaddis Legacy Awards, and the highest award that I give out in theater is the Wendell Tabb Director's Award. So stand by because those final awards are coming up. Right now, let's go to the talented Miss Tiffany Agerston for her top award in theater. I'm sorry, in chorus.
Thank you, Mr. Tabb. We could not capture all of these amazing moments without the technical support of photography and videography. Please join me in saluting our photographers, Mr. Gene Tatum, Mr. Devin Edwards, and our videographer, Mr. Kenneth Hinton. We cannot thank you enough for allowing us the opportunity to archive these special moments that will last us for a lifetime. Congratulations, Mr. Gene Tatum, Mr. Devin Edwards, and Mr. Kenneth Hinton. Thank you for your creative vision and for capturing our special moments in the performing arts. We honor you. We have come to the moment of the night that many of you have been waiting for, the top awards for chorus. When your name is called, you will have 15 seconds to give an acceptance speech for receiving your award. Don't forget to unmute and remute. Tonight, we honor a remarkable student with the Gloria Timberlake Hall of Fame Award. In 1969, Miss Gloria Timberlake began teaching at Hillside High School, where she served as choral director until her retirement in the 90s. We love her. Her love for music was evident through her work as a music teacher. She found joy working with people of all ages and always set her expectations high. Mrs. Timberlake's philosophy on teaching can be summarized in her own words. It is my firm belief that the only things that keep you bound are the only things that you need to let go. What I have, I pass on to others. I must pass on my enthusiasm, skill, my love for music, my concern for others, the tenderness I developed, and the courage to give love to young people I come in contact with every day. The recipient of this award is passionate about music and artistic accuracy. This student represents what Hillside Chorus is all about. In learning about Mrs. Timberlake, I imagine that she would be very proud of you. This year's Gloria Timberlake Hall of Fame Award goes to Mr. Antoine Frazier. Congratulations, Antoine. You may now present your 15-second speech.
First, I would like to thank Miss A. First, I would like to thank Miss A and Mr. Tabb and everybody in the whole choral and theater department. And also, I would like to thank my mom and dad and everybody. And I would like to thank all like the parents who like took me in and fed me and stuff like that. And also, I want to thank like Glee Club and God, like overall, because you know, God been there. Hallelujah. So, yeah, thank you. Thank you again, Ms. A, and thank you, everybody. Love y'all.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Honorable T.H. Claggett Award. Teresa H. Claggett is credited for bringing classical music into the city schools. Ms. Claggett also founded and organized the North Carolina State Music Teachers Association. Ms. Claggett organized and directed the festival, our first festival in the state of North Carolina at Hillside in 1931. The Claggett Award was sanctioned on Sunday, May 7, 1967. Today, Hillside High School continues to honor Ms. Claggett's legacy with the T.H. Claggett Award at the Performing Arts Award Ceremony. The Claggett Award is the highest choral award that a student can receive at Hillside High School. The recipient of this award has shown musical talent and is in good academic standing. In a short time, this student has made a huge impact on our department. With a positive attitude and willingness to serve others, we cannot help but honor you tonight. This year's T.H. Claggett Award is none other than Senior Angela Holmes. Congratulations.
Hello. I just want to thank Ms. A for giving me the opportunity to lead and my family for supporting me, and Mr. Tab for giving me a chance to be a part of the play, and God, because without him, I would not be doing anything. Thank you.
And now we will zoom in from around the world with a performing arts alum.
Okay, do we have any more zooming in, a performing arts alum, before we go to the celebrities? Who did we miss? Oh, we're doing great. Okay, so now let's go see if I can get Darnell. Darnell, are you still there? We're trying to get Darnell Williams in from California. He's still trying to get in. Dr. Logan, I want you to see what's going on with technology now. So when I quit, you'll know why. It was technology. Okay. So we're still trying to get him in. Auntie Starletta, can you, can we hear you, Auntie Starletta? She's still trying to get hers to work as well. But she's texting me. She's sending her best regards to all the babies. I'll let you do Auntie Starletta. What would she say?
Hey, my babies. I love you. I love you, Hillside High School. I am raving about you in Los Angeles, California. Y'all continue to make me proud. The world watches. The world watches. I love you, babies. I love you, Mr. Tab. Y'all keep on hanging in there. I'm right here beside you in the voice of Auntie Starletta. We love you and we honor you and we thank you.
Thank you, Miss Agaston. Thank you so much. So where are we now? Did we miss anybody? Before we go to the next one, are we zooming into anybody? Are we good, Ms. Agerston?
Yes, sir. I believe we're good.
All right. I think it's back to you.
Yes, sir. This has been an amazing year for chorus, in spite of our shortened season. Our students did an amazing job, and we are so proud of them. Now to present the final awards for band, Miss Sybil Haskins.
Thank you, Miss Agaston. Tonight, Hillside Performing Arts is worldwide. We're sharing memories and keeping the moment of life by using the hashtag HillsideVPA2020. Don't forget to take a selfie. Now, we have come to the moment of the night that many of you have been waiting for, the top awards for band. Hillside High School's band has a rich legacy and a fan base within our community and our nation. Here are the top awards for band. Leadership and our highest honors, the John Philip Sousa Award, goes to Mr. Tyree Strickland. Congratulations, Tyree. If you are present, you may now have your 15-second speech. Okay. Well, he would say thank you so much. All right, and now I would like to announce our band leadership for the 2020-21 school year. Those names are as follows. Our flute section leader, Ms. Taji Terry, clarinet section leader, Ms. Randria Cody, saxophone section leader, Mr. Ryan Long, trumpet section leader, Ms. Tiana Cherry, mellophone section leader, Robert Taylor Jr., trombone, Kyler Stewart, euphonium, Ania Jones, tuba, Tyvell Brody, student director, Ms. Bernice Thompson, and the upper echelon, our drum majors, our two assistant drum majors, who will also be pulling double duty of playing when it's needed, will be Ania Jones and Zion Flood. And our head drum major is for the 2021 school year, Ms. Kayla Miles. Congratulations, Kayla. If you are present, you may now have your 15-second speech. Well, we will now have a Zoom in from around the world with the Performing Arts alum.
All right, Auntie Starletta is gonna try to do it again. Auntie Starletta, you wanna try it? Okay, let's see what Auntie Starletta said on the text, okay? Wow, thank you for the shout out by Miss A. You all are so loved. Okay, so Miss Starletta said, thank you, Tiffany. For impersonating her. All right, so we're gonna keep it moving. I just didn't want to miss anybody else because we're at the end of the program, near the end. All right. Okay, so as you, I believe Ms. Haskins is back to you.
Yes, sir. Well, thank you, Mr. Tab. We look forward to continuing the historic legacy of Hillside High School's band. Here to present the top awards for dance is the eloquent Miss Valencia Lipscomb.
Yes, yes, yes. I love eloquent. That was really good. Okay. Thank you, Ms. Haskins. This is it. With high anticipation and excitement, I present to you the top awards for dance. Hillside Dance has a national reputation for skill, achievement, and talent. When your name is called, you have 15 seconds to give an acceptance speech for receiving the following awards. And do not forget to unmute and remute. It's very important. Okay. Our top awards for dance company are as follows. For leadership on dance company, the awards go to Bailey Davenport. Is Bailey Davenport in for a 15-second speech?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead, Bailey. Congrats.
I just want to thank all the staff and my team for pushing me and my mom for always being here. Thank you, that's it.
And thank you, Bailey. For our second leadership award, because I had a huge company this year, Kalia Green. Is Kalia Green on to give her 15-second speech?
Yes, I'm right here. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Okay, love you. All right, most creative. So my two amazing dancers that received most creative, the first one is Janiyah Mormon. Is Janiyah Mormon on to give her 15-second speech? Okay, moving on. Our second most creative dancer goes to Zamaria Patterson. Is Zamaria on to give her 15-second speech?
Can y'all hear me?
Yes.
Hey. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Miss B, for everything. Well, thank you for everything you've done for me. And thank you, Mommy, for always being here. Always, you know. And thank all the rest of the staff and teachers for everything y'all have done for everybody. I really appreciate everybody. Thanks,
Zamaria. All right, and for most improved, we have first my girl, Ariana Young. Are you here, Ariana, for your 15-second speech?
Yes, I'm here.
Hey, pretty girl.
Hi, I just want to say thank you, V, for allowing me to grow and become a much better dancer from the little girl I used to be to, you know, getting my toe touches up there. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Love you.
You're welcome. Love you too. And our last award for company goes to our most improved, Nadia Rings. Is Nadia Rings on to give her a 15-second speech? Okay. So moving right along. Next is one of my first, these are the huge awards, everybody. So I'm going to go through it quickly and we're going to get it done. So first, I have my Captain's Award. This award goes to someone who had to learn to lead. And she took notes. She did exactly what was taught to her. She came to all of the board meetings with me and she learned her administration protocols and everything that she was supposed to do. She took roles, she reported back to me. And most of all, she exemplifies hard work, dedication, and exactly what a captain should be, which is a leader. So I want to give this award to a hard worker, Jay Scott Kirkland. I believe Jade is here. So if she's here, would you like your 15-second speech?
I'm here. Hi, I just want to thank my coach because without her, I wouldn't be the dancer I would be. And she's always pushing me and supporting me, even when I don't believe in myself. And I want to give a shout out to my team too, because they be pushing me too, even when I be ready to give up. So I'm just grateful for this award and to be able to be their captain. I love you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Jay. Okay, moving right along. Next is a big award that's so special to me. The Student Choreography Award is so important to me because choreography is my thing. It truly is my baby. With practice and dedication, anyone can learn to dance, but only those with true experience, natural talent, and passion can choreograph. I believe that I receive this award every single year of my high school career, and I believe that this person will continue to make me proud by doing the same thing. This dancer is not only special to Ms. Lipscomb, but is a true influencer academically as well. To my right hand, my assistant, and my newest protege, I present the Student Choreography of the Year Award again to Mr. Makai Burns for retaining, reteaching, and creating amazing works alongside Ms. Lipscomb. I appreciate you so much. Are you here for your speech?
Yeah, cute. Do you hear me?
Yes. Hi, Makai.
Hey. Thank you for pushing me, opening me up to new styles of choreo, and thank my team for working with me, trying to make stuff up on the spot. And yeah, I just really appreciate all y'all.
Thank you. All right, last two, y'all. Thank you for your patience. Next, we have our most valuable dancer. This MVD award goes to the dancer that has shown pure dedication to Hillside's dance company for up to 3 years of their high school career, performing in district events, school-led events, competitions, and community performances. This dancer has the ability to make her light evident to others through true beauty, steady intelligence, and by creating her own path and walking in it. This dancer has shown growth throughout their time in dance classes and has passed my course with a 3.2 GPA or better. This dancer is not only special to Ms. Lipscomb, but is a true influencer academically as well. The most valuable dancer that I'm going to miss so much is the senior award goes to IKEA Met. IKEA Metz is watching on YouTube Live, so she cannot give her speech, but I will talk to her, I'm sure, later. Call her mom. Okay, next. Congrats, IKEA. All right, last but not least, our Dancer of the Year Award. Dancer of the Year goes to the dancer that has shown pure dedication to Hillside's dance company for all 4 years of their high school career, performing in district events, school-led events, competitions, and community performances. This dancer has shown growth throughout their time in dance by exemplifying true leadership qualities, maintaining a positive team spirit, and possessing that Hornet star quality. This dancer is not only special to Ms. Lipscomb, but a true influencer academically as well.
Ladies and gentlemen, quick drum roll. Dancer of the Year 2019-2020 is Bailey Davenport. Congratulations, Bailey. Thank you, Myra. I love y'all. Are you here for your speech, Bailey?
I don't want to do the speech, but I could just say thank you.
You're welcome. Congrats. Okay, finally, I would like to announce my STEAM captain for the 2020 and 2021 school year. My STEAM captain, get ready to come back for your speech, will be Makai Burns. Are you here for a 5-second speech?
Yes. Yes, thank you. Thank you for helping me mature and step into that captain spot, and I really appreciate y'all.
Okay, alumni, we thank you for all of your support. Hillside Dance continues to break records and accomplish the unthinkable. Dancers, I honor you tonight. Now we will have we already did our Zoom from around the world. So I hope everyone is safe with their families during this time. At this moment, I would be announcing the newly handpicked dance company members, but due to the strenuous circumstances, I'm announcing that I'm holding tryouts in the 2020 and 2021 school year. So here to present the final, the biggest, what we've all been waiting for, the top awards for theater, our leader, Mr. Tab.
Thank you so much. Before I present those awards, I need to go back to Ms. Haskins. Ms. Haskins, do you need to repeat to announce something?
Yes, Mr. Tab, thank you. I wanted to announce the percussion section. Ladies, guys, please forgive me for that oversight. The wonderful Blue Steel section leaders are Ian Taylor, Antonio Whitfield, and Taquan Brown. Congratulations, guys. Blue Steel.
Thank you, Ms. Haskins. So now let's do a quick Zoom around the world before we do these last awards. Zoom around the world. I know there's Katie is on the line. Katie, I think you're Zooming in from like Tennessee. Katie, are you there?
I am. Hello. Coming at you from Nashville, Tennessee. I graduated Hillside in 2013. I'm now a PhD candidate in chemistry at Vanderbilt University. Just wanted to say congratulations to all the award winners. Your hard work has not gone unnoticed. You have really, you know, made the performing arts department what it is. And sometimes, you know, in life you have to be your own biggest advocate, but your second biggest advocate might come from this department. So well done. Can't wait to see what you guys come up with next year.
Thank you, Katie, and congratulations to you, doctor.
Not yet.
We got to claim it, and in chemistry. So we're going to claim that, and thank you for all your work and your leadership that you did here in theater. Appreciate you so much. And you're Zooming in from where? Let everybody know where you're Zooming in from again.
Nashville, Tennessee, Music City, USA.
All right. She's Zooming in from Tennessee. Thank you very much. And now we are ready. Thank you, Ms. Lipscomb. Thank you, Ms. Thank you, Ms. Agerston. Are we missing anybody else from around the world? Okay, nobody else from around the world. So here we go.
Oh, I think I was able to get in.
Okay, well, Auntie Scarletta, she's in.
Oh, my God. Oh, my goodness. I didn't sat here and figured it out. I'm going to be a big girl soon. You babies are amazing. I love you so much. This has been such a joy to see you being honored for all of your accomplishments. You all go out in the world and y'all just do it. Please. I'm grateful and honored to just be able to hang out there with you all whenever I come down. Thank you so much, Ms. A, Mr. Tapp, and I figured this out. God bless you all. Stay safe.
Thank you. And you are Zooming in from where?
From Los Angeles, California.
All right. Well, thank you, Auntie. And Auntie Starletta is our national spokesperson for theater. And she's been telling all the celebrities about Hillside Theater. And so a lot of the work that we're able to do here and the people that are able to come here is because of Auntie Starletta. So I want to give you that credit, Auntie Starletta. So thank you so much. I want to just check in with Darnell Williams one more time. Darnell, are you there? Okay, so here we go. Thank you all so very much. Although we were unable to finish our season of Matilda, and I just want to tell some, we still had an amazing year with The Bodyguard, Hallelujah Swing School, and One Voice performances. God has truly been good to us, and I'm so thankful for all of these wonderful students and their parents. Now for the final top awards in theater. When your name is called, 15 seconds to give an acceptance speech for receiving the award. Don't forget to and then remute. Now I will present the final awards for theater. The final top awards in theater for Star Freshman of the Year. This award goes to Khalees Real. Khalees on the line.
I want to say thank you to all of you who have inspired me so far during my time in the drama department. I greatly appreciate everything y'all have taught me so far, and I'll forever be grateful for moments like these. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Khalees. Now, for our Star Actor of the Year, drum roll, please. Our Star Actor of the Year goes to Elijah Waddell. Are you on the line?
Yes, sir. I'm right here, Mr. Tapp. I just want to thank God, my mom, my grandmother, my little sister, all my peers, everyone that has supported me with this acting career and my journey through my 4 years in high school. Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, for our Star Actress of the Year, drum roll, please. Star Actress of the Year goes to Zayana Hinton. Zayana, are you on the line?
Yes. I would like to say thank you to Ms. Tab, Ms. Ackerson, my parents, my mom, and my grandparents, and all of my peers for helping me out. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, for the Star Male Performing Artist of the Year, that means they have to do more than one discipline in the arts. So, the Star Male Performing Artist of the Year, drum roll, please, is Ethan Guillon, Star Performing Artist of the Year. Ethan, are you on the line?
Yes, I am. I want to thank God first, because I know without God, I wouldn't be able to do any of this. I want to thank Mr. Tapp for believing in me and my mom. And I want to thank all the students for encouraging me on the way there. Thank you.
Thank you. For our Star Female Performing Artist of the Year, which means they have to do more than one discipline. Our Star Female Performing Artist of the Year, drum roll please, is Nicaea Williams. Is Nicaea on the line?
Sorry, y'all. Hey, y'all. Oh, thank you so much. I was not expecting this. I don't know what to say, but thank you, Mr. Tab. I love y'all. Thank y'all. Okay, I'm done.
Thank you. For the John H. Gaddis Theater Legacy Award, this is in recognition of the leader for Hillside High School, to John H. Gaddis. This is a huge award. We are giving out four of these awards. For the John H. Gaddis Theater Legacy Award, goes to Disney DeBerry. Are you on the line, Disney?
Wow. Okay. First, I want to give thanks to God, you know, the glory. I want to thank, you know, all my performing arts teachers, Ms. Haskins, Ms. Agerston, Mr. Tab, Ms. Lipscomb, Dr. Logan. I just want to thank all of y'all ever since I got here 2 years ago. And like, I feel like I've achieved and improved on, you know, so many things. And it's, whew, I'm hot. Like, I'm surprised right now. But thank you, Mr. Tab, for this award. I appreciate it. Thank you. Love you.
Thank you. Love you too. The John H. Gaddis Theater Legacy Award goes to Cameron Sneed. Is Cameron on the line? Cameron on the line? Okay, next, our John H. Gaddis Theater Legacy Award. These are top awards for theater. This award goes to Daryl Thompson.
Can everybody hear me? I would like to thank God above all, and then I would like to thank my parents and everybody else who supported me throughout my high school journey in the Hillside Drama Department. Thank you.
And our final theater, John H. Gaddis Theater Legacy Award, goes to Amaya Tillery. Is Amaya on the line?
Hey, Mr. Tab, I just want to thank God first of all, and I would like to thank you and Ms. A for all the help and the guidance over the time. You know, I was a bit difficult at times, but you really helped me to grow. And I want to thank all my peers for, you know, pushing me. And yeah, thank you.
Thank you. And now, the top award in theater. This is our final award in theater. It's for performing arts success on and off the stage through academics, performance, management, and directorship in the award-winning Hillside Theater Program. The Wendell Tabb Director's Award is the top award in theater. Drum roll, please. The Wendell Tabb Director's Award goes to Kaya Brown. Kaya, you on the line.
I would like to say thank you to everybody who's been supporting me. Thank you, Mr. Tab, for continuously teaching me everything that I know about. And I look forward to learning more. Thank you.
Thank you, Kaya. Now, those are all of our final awards for theater. I want to congratulate all of the students in theater. It was a lot of awards given out. I do have all of you all's awards that are ready for you. I will let you know when you can pick those awards up. I will try to coordinate that with Dr. Logan to see when other people are coming back to the school to pick up stuff so that we can just have one trip for all. So just know that I do have the awards ready for you. We will now have our final Zoom in from around the world with a performing arts alumni or a celebrity. Ms. Agerson, did we miss anybody?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ms. Crystal Roscoe.
Crystal. Crystal, where are you? Crystal? Okay, we'll see if we can get her. Crystal is probably zooming in from Atlanta. All right, Ms. Agerson?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we have Mr. Darnell Williams.
Can you see me? Can you hear me?
Yes, he's here. He's finally here, Mr. Williams.
Oh, it's been quite a journey just to get zooming.
Right. Darnell, let them all know where you're zooming from.
I'm zooming from Victorville, California, in my house. It's a pleasure to be here. I just wanted to thank you for inviting me. Congratulations to all the to the graduates and all the award winners. God bless you. I can't help but remember or think fondly about the memories I had in high school when my journey began. It helps me realize that education is the foundation. You know, it's a blessing, it's a right. And once this foundation is placed, you have to be specific as to what your goal is and then go for it. Be vigilant, be ruthless, and be a winner. Be successful as you are. God bless you. And congratulations.
Mr. Williams, thank you so much. I just want you to know that you caused my sisters and I to have a lot of fights in high school because they wanted to watch all my children, to watch Jesse and Angie on all my children, and I couldn't watch what I wanted to watch. So I ended up growing up watching you as well because of my sisters. So
well, my apologies.
That's okay, because you had a big impact. So I end up watching all my children too. So thank you so much for all of your work in the industry. Thank you for leading the way for so many others that saw you on television to be able to say, I can do that too. So
absolutely. It's been my pleasure. Absolutely. I'm glad you've been able to inspire or be inspired from my inspiration. Yeah, absolutely.
Cool. Thank you so much, so very much. Ms. Agerson, is there anybody else did we lose before we go to the last slide?
Ladies and gentlemen, I see Malik Dixon. Malik Dixon.
Malik, Mike Dixon, he's zooming in from Australia, I believe.
Yo, how you guys doing?
Hello, Mike.
What's going on? Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay. Yeah, I just Rashad told me to check my email. And you know what? I was a little bit I was neglecting my emails. You know, I got a newborn, so you know, I be kind of tied up with that thing, man. But it's all good. It's good to see everybody. Good to see some brown faces.
Right. Tell them where you're zooming in from.
I'm zooming in from Sydney, Australia, over here with Travis. Travis, I just passed Travis's neighborhood just now. I'm just driving at the moment.
Right. So that lets the students know wherever they go, they got a Hillside connection wherever they go.
Absolutely. Let me know. Anytime. If I can help, I'll definitely help anybody out. Mr. Tab, you know, when last time you were here, we had a good time last time you were here. It was good to see you, man. Good to see somebody from the neighborhood.
Thank you. I've been to Australia twice, once with the students and once doing a show, directing a show over there with them. And Malik made sure he took care of me. It's always good. And when I had him in my class, I knew then, I said, that boy's going places. So Malik, thank you for zooming in, taking the time. What time is it there?
It's about almost midday on, almost 12 on, what day is it? It's Thursday.
On Thursday. Okay.
So remember this bridge right here in town?
Yes, absolutely. Thank you. Thank you, Dixon, for taking the time to give back to Hillside for speaking to the students. Thank you for zooming in from Australia.
Thanks for having me, man. You guys have
thank
a good
you. Thank you. Ms. Agerson, I think it's all yours, right?
Yes, sir.
Maybe it's me.
I'm sorry, say that one more time, Mr. Tam.
I'll take it, Ms. Agerson. This has been an awesome night. Let's make sure we didn't miss anyone from around the world. I think we're clear with that. Agerson, we're clear?
Yes, sir.
All right, then it's all yours.
What an unpredictable year this has been. In spite of this global pandemic, our seniors have been resilient, relentless, patient, caring, creative, innovative, and triumphant. In the words of the late Dr. Maya Angelou, still I rise. Let's take a look at the seniors then and now. Ladies and gentlemen, the world salutes our seniors. Let's see some of those seniors. It's your time.
Shattered, but I'm not broken. Wounded, but time will heal. Heavy the load, the cross I bear. Lonely the road I try.
Thank you, seniors. We are so fortunate at Hillside High School to have outstanding parents who are hardworking, nurturing, and committed to our students. We could not run our performing arts program without the support of our parents. They are the backbone to the success and continued legacy of Hillside Performing Arts. We salute our parents, and we will give two of them from each department a chance to have final remarks. From chorus, we have Ms. Angela Holmes and Ms. Brewster. We will hear from Ms. Angela Holmes now. Ms. Holmes?
Yes, hello. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Hi, I just want to congratulate the Hillside High School chorus for all your phenomenal work, as well as the teachers and all the other departments. And to my baby, Angela, I am so proud of you, sweetie. And you all keep on keeping on. And when you go out in this world, just let them know how well a hornet can sting. Take care, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you. Mrs. Brewster. Ms. Brewster. Ms. Brewster, are you there?
Yes, I would like to congratulate all the seniors and all the students performing arts. I want to let you guys know that you did an awesome job this year. And just keep going, keep pushing. You are absolutely awesome.
Thank you. Now from band, we'll have Ms. Campbell to speak. Ms. Campbell, are you there?
I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Good evening, Hillside. So just really quickly, congratulations to the class of 2020 and now to all of my students in Immortal Sting. You guys did an amazing job this year. You should be so very proud of yourselves because you put in some phenomenal work. Ms. Haskins and the band staff, thank you so much for all that you do to teach, grow, groom, educate, and allow our students to cultivate the amazing marching band that we have at Hillside. And of course, to my band parents, thank you so much for all of the support that you provide. We could not do this without you. And to my graduating bandsmen, job well done to you guys. Congratulations to you. We're definitely gonna miss seeing your faces next year in band season. So again, congratulations to all of the award recipients this evening and to the class of 2020. Go out and make your mark on this world, and remember, there is nothing that you cannot achieve. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We'll now go to Ms. Lipscomb. Ms. Lipscomb, do you have a parent representative? Ms. Lipscomb? Okay, we will now move to theater. Ms. Atwater and Ms. Jarman. We'll start with Ms. Atwater.
Hello, everyone. I just want to say congratulations to everyone on their awards. Congratulations to the class of 2020. Thank you, Ms. A, Ms. Z, Mr. Tab. We love you so much. We're going to miss you. Thanks.
Thank you. Ms. Jarman.
Okay, I'm coming. Okay. All right. You saved the most dramatic parent for last.
We don't see you.
Okay, can you see me there?
Yes.
All right. So, real quick. First, we must thank you, Mr. Tab, for your immeasurable dedication to the students of Hillside, to the students to Hillside, the supporters and sponsors of Drama Department. You are a gifted visionary. You see the visions and you bring them to life, to give life to the students and to the audiences. What I have found during my time as a theater parent is that your visions for the students are present and future. You are cultivating leaders who we know are desperately needed in minority communities. Your students are leading in high school and in college, even as freshmen. The confidence they leave Hillside with is a jewel that will propel them forward to, as they move through life as young adults. To my fellow drama parents, we applaud all of you, us, for the long nights waiting for rehearsals to end, the early days during play weeks, the volunteering during shows, the unfailing support for your child and even others. The support we give to the program and Mr. Tab as parents is one of the main things that help keep the program running smoothly. Lastly, to the students, you are the generation that will be one of the strongest on the planet. You got knocked down a little, but got back up swinging. Survivors, stars, conquerors, champions. You took lemons and made lemonade. Now, lastly, they, whoever they may be, don't have to ever recognize Hillside in any special programs for us to know our theater program, our drama department, our chorus, our band, dance, are the best in the land. We are hornets, and there is nothing that can diminish our sting.
Well, thank you so much. We really appreciate the theater parents. Y'all know I love you all so very much. And thank you for taking a lot of things off my plate that I always do myself. So thank you all so, so very much. All right, we're at the end. Thank you all so very much for Zooming in with us tonight. We could not have a successful performing arts program or have an awesome school without the leadership and support of our principal, Dr. William T. Logan, and our administrator over the arts, Mr. Rashad Lee Worthy. Before they give final remarks, is Derek Pintel on? Anybody that we missed? Because I don't want anybody to Zoom in and we didn't give them a chance. So just Zoom right in right now if we missed anybody. I hear somebody Zooming in. No? Okay. Dr. Logan, are you still on? You still on? Oh my, well, thank you. is Mr. Lee Worthy still on? So we will now turn it over to Dr. Logan. I know he gave his remarks at the beginning, but now that he's seen all the students, the whole program, we do want to give him an opportunity to give final remarks. And to Mr. Lee Worthy, who is over our department as the administrator, we thank him so much for all of his leadership. Dr. Logan, can you close us out?
Certainly. Again, congratulations to everyone on a job well done. To my colleagues, Mr. Tab, Ms. Adderston, Ms. Haskins, Ms. Lipscomb. I was telling Dr. Hardy and Dr. Mubinga earlier, like I have never participated in a Zoom like this before. And I actually had the opportunity to share it with my family back home in Charleston. So when you saw me looking down, they were texting me, you know, making jokes and stuff like that. But I'm so, so appreciative of all of your hard work and your efforts. And again, to our students, job well done. I know you all were really psyched about performing Matilda, and things didn't pan out the way we wanted them to, but God is still good all the time. To our parents, I want to thank you for your continued support and dedication and commitment, because none of this would be if it weren't for your support. Ms. Mason just talked about the long hours and the early mornings that it takes to make a program like this come to fruition, and that's the kind of sacrifice and dedication that it takes for us to get to this point. And so again, I thank our parents and to the friends of our arts program, the alumni. Thank you all for coming back. It was so good to see all of your faces. Casey, you know how much I love you. I was telling my cousins, you were the person that actually made me fall in love with Hillside Theater Program and arts program, because I saw you perform and I was telling them you were the first person I saw dance, sing, and act at the same time. Like I had never seen anything like that from a student. And so I thank you, and it's so great to see you. And God continue to bless you and all of your efforts. And to all of our alumni, the same thing. Lindsay, I thought you were going to perform tonight. I was so looking forward to hearing your voice. But prayerfully, I'll have to see it or hear it again some other time. But it's great to see you on screen. And again, Mr. Kaysen, Ms. Hyman. It's great to see you, to the SS Renaissance. Thank you all for being here. And again, you all make Hillside what it is, the greatest school in the state of North Carolina. And I put my head on the chopping block saying it is the greatest school in the nation. So thank you all. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Be safe out there.
Thank you, Ms. Agston.
I want to render a special thank you to our virtual production staff who has worked so hard to make this evening amazing. To our Hillside Performing Arts Show producers, Matthew White, Emmanuel Tabb, and Jordan Jarman. To our Durham Public Schools producers, Mr. William Tomlinson and Kyle Yerby. Our videographers and video designers, Mr. Kenneth Hinton, Devin Edwards, and Kaya Brown. To our musical entertainment, Tyra Scott and Casey McCall Moore. And to our production team who worked on all of our productions and concerts this year. We love you and we thank you. Congratulations to all our performing arts students, parents, supporter, alumni, celebrity guests, and the community at large. We cannot do any of this without your support. On behalf of Ms. Lipscomb, Ms. Haskins, Mr. Tabb, and yours truly, we say thank you. Thank you for loving our children. And now let this final song for tonight resonate with you wherever you may be in the world. Tears streaming down, her heart is broken because her life is hurting, so am I. He wears a frown, his dreams are choking, and because he stands alone, his dreams will die. So humbly I come to you and say, as I sound aloud the warfare of today, hear me, I pray, what about the children? To endure is so easy, so many innocent children who would choose the wrong way. What about the children? Remember when we were children, and if not for those who loved us and who cared so much to show us, where would we be today? Thank you all so very much. Hillside High School Performing Arts Awards 2020 ceremony zooming out. Everybody wave goodnight.